Dinos just coming onto the field. The Bisons waiting for them on their bench on the east side at McMahon Stadium. Great fall day for football. It has been a cold and miserable week in Calgary, but today the weather gods smiling on us. The sun came out. The temperature expected to hit double digits as we get into this game here, getting a little bit slower to warm up at this time of year. Dave Rowe and Tony Spallatini here to bring you the play-by-play action of the 5-0 Calgary Dinos taking on the Manitoba Bisons. Tony, it's been a long year for Brian Dobie and his crew, just the one win on the year.
Well, yeah, so much more expected of this Bison football team. It's a football team, Dave, loaded with talent on both sides of the football. I think the players, along with the coaches, are probably disappointed that they haven't lived up to their expectations. And that's why games like this, you call them the trap game, a game where a 5-0 team doesn't want to come in overconfident. They're saying the right things, they're doing the right things all week, but you just can't help but maybe think this is going to be a gimme, and you got to be really careful, because the longer the Bison stay in the game, the longer there's going to be a greater fight. So if you're the Dinos, you want to take him out early, Dave, and you want to keep the pressure on.
Referee Daryl Hearn and his crew are at midfield along with the captains for the coin toss. And yeah, as you say, coming off a bye week, and the week before that, the Dinos went into UBC for a key showdown against the Thunderbirds with first place on the line. Dinos came out of that with a 31-17 win. Now, they haven't locked up first place in Canada West yet. They need a win today and a little bit of help to get that accomplished. But as you say, they are going to have to keep the energy up. Just waiting for the results of the coin toss. It looks like Calgary winning the toss and deferring, and that is the choice that you'd expect, because all of a sudden, Tony, after a pretty calm morning in the last few minutes, we've had a not insignificant breeze start to kick up out of the north.
Well, exactly. You know, pulling into the stadium about an hour ago, Dave, and even, like you said, up until about 5 minutes ago, I thought we were going to have just a nice, still game, and you can see it picking up there a bit. I mean, I think not enough to warrant it being an issue for the passing game, but still enough of a win to make the deferral call.
Daryl Hearn's crew, umpire Francois Cordemanche, Dan Mulvihill is the head linesman, Duncan Nass the line judge, the side judge is Emily Clark, the back judge is Rob Sherman, and the field judge is Sean Kerr. So the Bisons are going to start this game on offense, and as you say, Des Cattelier, the local boy out of St. Francis High School, getting his third start, is going to try and shine against the hometown University of Calgary Dinos. Play-by-play just a moment away. Now, let's have our national anthem.
And join Megan Traz in the singing of our national anthem.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Live from McMahon Stadium, we are moments away from kickoff between the Calgary Dinos and the University of Manitoba Bisons. Manitoba going to start with the ball, and as we mentioned, the storyline from a Calgary standpoint, Des Cattelier, the local boy out of St. Francis, taking over the offense after that 76-17 shellacking that the Dinos laid on Manitoba in Winnipeg a few weeks ago. And Tony, a completely different look for the offense under Cattelier. Theo Dizar, the incumbent who lost his job to Cattelier, he was more of a vertical quarterback, just throw the bomb downfield and go for those 50-50 catches. Brian Dobie looking for a little bit more of a possession precision game out of Cattelier.
Well, exactly. When you're going downfield vertical, as you stated, Dave, it's either a completion, and if it's not, then you're 1-2 and out, 1-2 and out. You're not chewing much of the clock. And if you're playing against a team like the Dinos that have so many weapons, you can see how that score got from 7 to 14 to 21, because your offense is hardly on the field, your defense gets tired, and then the other team just starts lighting it up, Dave.
Two receivers deep for the Manitoba Bisons, Shea Ross and Jesse Walker. Normally, they go with their running back, Jamel Lyles, back there to return kicks. Maybe a bit of a question about his health. 886 total yards. He is a weapon out of the backfield. The Dinos coach Wayne Harris and his defense very concerned about.
Very, very unique back, Dave. He can do it all. He's tough. He can run. He can catch out of the backfield. That's what makes him so special. That's a great qualities, especially to go on to the next level in the CFL.
Nico DeFonte set to kick it up, and that breeze blowing the ball over at the 45-yard line. I always hate that. It's almost anticlimactic at the start of the game. All keyed up for the kickoff, and then whoop, down it goes.
More than likely, Dave, you'll probably go with a moonshot. But usually when you're kicking into that wind, you kick it up nice and high. It hangs up there for your kickoff team to maybe have a crack at it.
And Ross and Walker are thinking about that, and they are cheating up. And instead, DeFonte puts this one deep. That big leg takes it all the way into the end zone. It's going to roll out the back. We're not even going to roll any time off the clock. And the Dinos are going to take a 1-0 lead.
Again, that just shows you how strong his leg is, Dave. I mean, he kicked that ball over 60 yards into a stiff breeze. DeFonte, no question that he's got the leg to make those long kicks if he has to.
Des Cattelier leading his offense out on the field. Got a clap on the back encouragement from his head coach. Dino defense. And their mission statement today is to get in the face of that young quarterback. Just make him hurry, try to force him into bad decisions.
And you know, Dave, they're going to have to get pressure, because Coach Rapini has some injuries there, and he's playing some young guys in that secondary.
Yeah, we got a flag down on the field right away. Looks like a 13 men in the huddle.
13 men in the huddle. The offense. It's a 10-yard penalty. Still first down.
Okay, so that is not the way that you want to start here. You give up the single point on the kickoff, and then you take a 10-yard penalty to make it first and 20 from your own 25-yard line. Cattelier has Jamal Lyles in the backfield with him. Hand off. Lyles is going to try to take it around the left-hand side. Cuts up to the 30, about to the original line of scrimmage, the 35-yard line. It's going to be second down and 10.
Well-run counterplay, Dave, there, where Jamal Lyles starts to his right, and then he comes back to the left. They pull the right guard, who does a beautiful job of kicking out the Dino defensive end. Jamal Lyles sees the gap, hits it full speed, and gets 10 of those yards back.
And a little bit thin in the defensive backfield are the Dinos. Cyril Iwanabe and the Stats twins, Nick and Aaron, are both out for this game. Dean Leonard getting the start at corner. Empty backfield, under pressure, and down goes Cattelier. And getting to him, Jack McEwen.
Again, Jack McEwen, that powerful nose guard out of Notre Dame High School, just blows up the center guard gap, and right in the face of Cattelier, the former St. Francis Brown quarterback could barely get set up and set his feet, and Jack McEwen was all over him.
Sack Jack. Yeah, yes. Sack Jack getting his fourth of the year. That ties him for the team lead, along with Corey Robinson. Manitoba forced to punt. Matt Riley going to boot this one away from about his 15-yard line. A bit of a wobbler. Dean Leonard settles under it at the 45-yard line, cuts to the hash marks and up, and he'll get to midfield before he's brought down. Good to see Dean Leonard back running kicks. He was a bit of a question mark, as he's been battling a bit of a sore hamstring this week.
And again, Dave, Dean Leonard, a rookie from Notre Dame High School, extremely fast, one of the top track sprinters, even though he's more of a football player than a track guy. Just got natural speed, and if that guy gets free, he's gone.
Adam Sinagra leading the offense up to the line. Jeshrin Antwi starting in the backfield, splitting off wide to the left-hand side is Justin Dasiak. That is where Sinagra is looking. Hits Dasiak up at the 50-yard line, and he can't elude two Manitoba defenders. He'll have a gain of 5, second down and 5.
And again, that time, Sinagra, a lot of time to sit in the pocket. He sends three receivers wide left. The two inside receivers, Dave, clear and go deep. The secondary follow them, and that just leaves Dasiak to settle down as he did, about 8 yards deep. Nice completion there for second and 2. for the Dinos.
Sinagra connecting at 73.5%. Second down and a manageable five. Sinagra with time as the pocket closes. He releases out of the backfield to Antwi. Antwi goes backwards, goes forwards to the sideline, has the first down, cuts back inside, taken down at about the 31-yard line.
Again, when you get a lot of time, Dave, you can go to your third read. That for Adam Sinagra was his third read. I mean, he looked left. His two deep reads were covered. He had a lot of time. His check down, the running back was able to come out of the backfield and just check down over the middle. Sinagra dumps it to him. And when you get a talent like Jeshron Antwi open in open field, he does what he just did there and was able to get some good extra yards after catch.
And the last time that we saw the Dinos here at McMahon Stadium a couple of weeks ago at a 51-28 win over Saskatchewan, Antwi had to carry the bulk of the load. Robbie Stewart, his running compatriot, was injured for that game, but Stewart back, so we'll start to see more of him in the second quarter. Antwi will carry the load through the first 15 minutes of the game. Receivers in motion to the left, first and 10 from the 32. Sinagra again steps up into the pocket, fires incomplete down at the 20-yard line. That one intended for Michael Klukas.
Again, that time Klukas, the usually sure-handed receiver, basically should have extended his run a little more. He dove a little bit early, and it just missed him over the outstretched fingers. What we need to comment, Dave, is how well the protection is when they're actually starting two rookies right out of high school at left and right tackle, the Dinos.
519 yards, six touchdowns for Klukas. Sinagra, under a little bit of pressure, releases out of the backfield to Antwi. Antwi takes it over to the sideline, cuts it back inside the 20-yard line, and it's going to be another Dinos first down. And again, that relief valve in Antwi just providing a little bit of explosiveness.
Well, that's just a design screen, Dave, right? Second and long, you know Manitoba's going to bring the house. They did. Sinagra sucked him in, dumped the ball over to Antwi. What Antwi did nice there, he caught it, was ahead of his tackle. He slowed down to allow his lineman to provide the block, and then he read the block and got the first down. Great running.
Cole Adamson checks in as an interior lineman for Winnipeg. Handoff to Antwi. He tries the left-hand side of the line. He'll get down to about the 15-yard line. That's a gain of three.
Again, looked like a nice initial push on the right side there. Jeshron had to cut it back to the short side, but usually when you're basically all the linemen are slanting to the right, the weak side end was open there for Manitoba and was able to trip up Jeshron Antwi for a short gain.
Dinos with a 1-0 lead. We're just about 4 minutes into the first quarter here as the Dinos taking on the University of Manitoba. Receivers in motion left. That's where Sinagra's looking as time again. Looks into the end zone, has a man. Touchdown, Dinos.
Again, just a beautiful corner route. It was man coverage. I believe it was Klukas. You get Klukas one-on-one, Dave, with that speed. Wasn't a pretty spiral, but he put just a beautiful arc high enough that he dropped it over the defender right into the hands of his own receiver. Beautiful route, beautiful throw, Dinos.
And we got a couple of angles on the replay, and I believe this was Hunter Carl with the sixth touchdown catch of the year. And Carl, with a great pattern, just able to get in behind the Manitoba defender, Shea Weeks.
Again, I stand corrected. Hunter Carl, another explosive receiver. Exactly, Dave. But the beauty of this was that Sinagra put it only where his receiver could catch it. Now, if you throw that route a little bit shallow, Dave, the defender can get the ball, can get his hand up and knock that ball down. He dropped it high like he was dropping it into a bucket, and it just basically went right into Hunter Carl's breadbasket.
And Sinagra able to toss that ball because, again, that win we were talking about, it's been up and down. Looked like it dropped down a little bit just in time for that play. But again, a nice touch pass by Sinagra. Good to see him back on his game. Again, the last time out here for the Dinos in Calgary a couple of weeks ago, he struggled in the third quarter, was throwing interceptions, making bad decisions. Actually got sacked, sat down in favor of Josiah Joseph, but absolutely no quarterback controversy for Wayne Harris. This is your number one guy.
What I'm really impressed with, Dave, is those two right out of high school tackles, Logan Bandy from St. Francis and Tyler Packer from Notre Dame. I mean, this is a veteran Manitoba defensive line, and those two young guys are giving Adam Sinagra a lot of time to throw that football.
Shea Ross is back deep. And Defonte is going to drive this one a little bit shorter, taken at the 10-yard line. Good coverage at the by the Dinos, but cutting back and up to the 32-yard line is Jesse Walker. Looked like they had Walker contained, but he was able to cut left and open that up for a good return.
Again, Jesse Walker, one of the top recruits coming out of British Columbia High School football, I believe, 2 or 3 years ago. You can see just why. That was a great kick. We talked about it, that moonshot. The cover team formed the net around him, but Jesse Walker, very shifty. Very good at changing direction. He did that and got some great yardage.
8-0 for the Dinos as Descatellier takes over. Second possession. Jamel Lyles is in the backfield. Receivers collapse on the line. Hand off to Lyles. He's going to try the right side, turn the corner, string it out to the 40-yard line. He'll have about 6 yards.
Again, that was well defended there by the Dinos. The interior lineman there of the Dino defensive line plugged all the inside gaps, forced Lyles to get outside. But you can see just how fast he is. It looked like they had him, and he was still, with his incredible speed, got around the corner and was able to blaze it up the sidelines for a solid 7-yard gain.
And positive yardage for Manitoba. Second and a very manageable three. Keep the playbook open. Shea Ross splits off on the short side of the field on the right. And there is the completion to Jesse Walker, and Walker gets smothered right away at the 42-yard line. Looks like he's going to come up short.
And I think he just got the first down, Dave, but there you go, Dave. When you get in those solid first down gains, you know, you get 5, 6, 7 yards on first down, you don't have to go downfield. You can hit those little quick outs, those little quick hooks, and then when you get the ball into the hands of an explosive player like Jesse Walker, he's one broken tackle away from a big play.
And Catelia, as you'd expect, going to his go-to guys. Jesse Walker, Lyles in the backfield. There's the handoff, a little bit of a counter. It's a room again on the right-hand side of the line. Moving the pile down to the 49-yard line is Jamel Lyles. That will be second down and about 7 yards.
Again, the Manitoba Bison offense coordinator figures he's got a mismatch with the counter, and initially looked like there was a nice gap there. Lyles going from his left to right, but a good job there by the interior line of the Dinos, able to get a hand on him, not let go of that cloth until he got help from his linebackers, and that limited Lyles to a 3-yard gain.
Second down, the ball just short of the 50-yard line, about 9 minutes to go in the first quarter. Telly in the eye, Lyle stays in the block, picks up a blitz, and there is a completion at midfield. This one looks like it's going to be just short of the first down to Stephen Ugba.
Again, just a nice route by Stephen Ugba. He knows, he didn't realize how far he had to go down. He should have gone probably past the yardsticks and then come back. He went down only about 9 yards, came back, hooked up around 8, and he's a little bit short, Dave. But looks like they're going to go for it. They're at midfield. They've got nothing to lose. I like this call. Gamble, you're gonna get it, and you got the momentum.
That's a great call by Brian Dobie. This is a short yard as the ball is marked just on the Dino side of midfield. And straight ahead into the line. I think that's Dizar that they bring in on short yardage. He surges ahead for 4 yards at a first down.
Well, Dizar is a big, big quarterback. I believe he's 6'4 plus, about 215 pounds. And that time, the left side of that Bison line, their guard McMorris, tackle Clarkson, got some great push. Dizar didn't waste it. He took the snap, felt his way to the left, saw a crease, and just exploded up for a good 3-yard gain there, Dave.
Good drive by the Bisons, doing what they have to do, working the ground game, getting some short passes in, and not giving that Dinos rush time to get to young Descatellier. Play action for Catelier. Looks out of the flat, has a man complete, down to the 40, the 35. And that is Macho Bokru, the wide receiver.
And again, just a great read there that time by Catelier. But you see, you give him a lot of time to throw the ball. He's very cerebral. Again, that was his third read. He looked downfield. First guy wasn't open. Second guy wasn't open. He has his wide out underneath who was being covered by a linebacker. And I love that matchup, Dave, all the time. You got Bokru on a linebacker. He gets 3 yards on him and a great completion and catch.
Good open field tackle by the veteran Adam Lorenz, starting at halfback this week. Play action again. In trouble is Catelier, and down he goes as he dives ahead to the 32-yard line. Again, turned absolutely nothing into a gain of about 2 yards.
Again, Descatelier, very, very shifty. Was able to sidestep the first Dino defender who was able to get in clean. Little stunt in the middle, Dave. And I believe it was Corey Robinson was able to come free.
Looking for that fifth
sack. Yeah, but good job by Cotillier not losing any yards and actually gaining a yard on that play.
Second down and 8 for the Bisons. Creeping into the red zone down to the Dinos, 33-yard line. Receivers in motion left. Straight drop, under pressure, fires over the middle as he gets hit. And that ball falling well short of Jesse Walker. And Cotillier taking a shot.
Again, the Dinos that time, Dave, just totally overloading the left side of that Bisons offensive line. There was more Dinos than the Bisons could cover, and then they also sent pressure up the middle. When you gamble like that, you got to get to the quarterback fast or he's going to make you pay. That time the Dinos got there quick enough where Cotillier just couldn't set his feet and make the throw.
So the Dinos holding Manitoba. The Bisons are going to try for a field goal. Jacob Esquerdo is deep just in case this one misses. Brad Mikuloff setting this one up just over 40 yards. Jaden McCoy puts it down. And this one splits the uprights. Manitoba on the board with 6:40 to go. Nice golf swing for Mikuloff to celebrate as it's now 8-3.
Again, looked like Adam Lorenz came through there clean, Dave, and almost got the block. But even though the Bisons maybe would have enjoyed a touchdown, they still did a great job, as we talked about earlier, Dave, of just picking, running the ball, short passes, chewing up some clock, giving their defense a time to rest, and building up some confidence. So if I'm Brian Dobie, I'm happy with that drive, Dave. That's what they need to do. They need to keep that Dino offense off the field and continue to get positive yards on first down so that Des Cotillier can make the quick, short passes on second down.
And a quality drive for the Bisons gets them on the board. Once again, Manitoba with just one win on the year under Des Cotillier. They went in to Regina and beat the Rams 18-16 a couple of weeks ago.
So, I mean, that tells you, Dave, that they do have the talent when they can put it together, because that Regina Ram football team is a good football team. I mean, anybody on Canada West, Dave, on any given day can beat anybody. There's good talent across this these western provinces, and you got to bring it every day.
Speaking of any given day, how about today, as we have an officials timeout on the field? The out-of-town scoreboard today also getting underway at the same time as our game. Regina at Alberta, UBC at Saskatchewan is going to be a later start at Griffith Stadium. Dinos break the huddle. Michael Klukas setting up to the left. Dinos start with a double tight end set. There's the handoff to Antwi on the right-hand side of the line, trying to pick a lane. He's going to get up to about the 39-yard line. Ball's out. Manitoba says they have it.
Come on, baby.
We're waiting for the official signal. And Manitoba have recovered. We'll see if we get a replay on this. Jeshrin Antwi. This looked like a routine run as he was headed for a gain of about 4 over by the sideline. All of a sudden, the ball popped out.
Looked like they were just running their base stretch play to the right, Dave. Looked like they got some solid push there. There was a crease. Jeshrin Antwi kind of waited patiently, shot up that crease, but looked like the ball got punched before he hit the ground. And again, just a positive momentum change here for the Bisons after coming off that great drive for the field goal.
So the Bisons have to be loving the way this game's starting for them. They take over at the Dino 38-yard line, first and 10, with about 6 minutes to go. Handoff inside, trying to bounce it out to the outside and counter it. Absolutely nowhere to go, and that is going to be a loss of about 3 yards for Jamel Lyles that time around. Great pursuit by Micah Tites and the Dino defense.
Again, here Manitoba going to the well too often. Dave, going back to that counter again. I believe it's the fourth time now. The Dinos have read the keys. They slanted right into that counter play that time, forcing Lyles to backtrack and a big loss here for the Bisons.
Second down and 14 now. The ball on the 42-yard line. Cotillier under pressure from both sides, gets it away as he's hit. That is complete. It's going to be a first down. Down to the 20-yard line is Shea Ross before he's knocked out of bounds.
Okay, as you can see there, Dave, the Dinos sent the house. There was no safety. That means it's man coverage that time, and it looked like maybe a little broken coverage on the wide side because they didn't get to Cotillier fast enough. He was able to get the ball off to the open receiver, and that's just a big hot read by Cotillier and a big first down for the Bisons.
And even though they didn't get to Cotillier, he has been hit a couple of times. That's the kind of thing that could stand you in good stead as the game wears on.
But you feel
but Cotillier with the completion to Shea Ross.
But you feel a lot better when you're getting big plays, though.
First and 10 from the 20-yard line. Rolling right, looking down towards the end zone, has a man! Touchdown, Manitoba! Jesse
Again.
Walker able to get the foot down. Does he beat his man to the outside?
Again, when you have a top running back like Lyles, that play action fake is going to freeze the linebackers and get the defensive halfback to look into the backfield. That time, the defensive halfback for the Dinos was caught looking in the backfield. Walker, ever explosive, was able to get a couple of steps on him on that corner route, and a beautifully placed ball by Des Cotillier right before the sideline there in the end zone. Great throw and catch by the Bisons.
And again, just a great pass to the spot. Put it where only his guy could get it. So inside 5 minutes to go, as the extra point goes through for Brad Mikula, 4:58 to go. The Bisons find themselves on top, 10-8. A little bit of a slow start for the University of Calgary Dinos.
And again, Dave, it goes to show you the character of the Bisons so far in this game. You know, the Dinos, boom, they get the ball, they march, they stop them, they get down, march down right away, score. If you're the Bisons, you're thinking, oh my God, are we going to get blown out again? But they didn't feel that way. They got the ball back on their second drive, drove down, got a field goal. Then they caused a turnover, scored a touchdown, they're in the lead. So if I'm the Bisons right now, I'm thinking, hey, guys, we're in this game. We can compete, and we can win this game.
Bobby Stewart back to receive the kickoff, along with Jacob Esquerdo. Jacob Esquerdo, a second-generation Dino, one of the younger players that Wayne Harris says is really starting to step up. Some of these kids have had an opportunity because of injuries, and one of them is the son of J.P. Esquerdo, making the most of his opportunity.
Again, comes from a great pedigree, Dave. Another athlete, freshman, right out of high school that's just given the coaches the confidence to put him in the game, making plays whenever he is in the game. And I got a feeling this kid's going to have a great career, just like his dad.
And the ball blowing off the tee for the Bisons. So Jaden McCoy, the holder, will come over. Put the finger down on the ball. Mikulov drives it down the field, taking a step into the end zone by Esquerdo, out to the 10, up the numbers to the 20, looking for a seam, gets to the 25-yard line where he is swallowed up.
Again, nice job by that Bison cover team. I believe it was a reserve linebacker that time, Kyle Gordon, making the play. Looked like Jacob had a nice little crease there, but Kyle Gordon comes off the block, tackles the big slot back, and the Dinos will be scrimmaging from their own 24-yard line, Dave.
And so the Dinos looking to atone. Jeshrit Antwi remains in the backfield. Again, the game plan is to have Antwi pretty much carry the load through the first quarter and then start rotating in Robbie Stewart. So he lines up in the eye, now splits off to the right, comes out of the backfield, long bomb downfield looking for Klukas, and Klukas, that ball held up. He tried to turn around and come back for it, unable to do it.
Again, it looked like Klukas was able to get a couple steps, the matchup you want. You got man coverage to the short side of the field. I don't know if that wind is swirling, Dave, but that ball just didn't come out clean from Sinegra. When you're kind of thrown into a swirling wind, you need that tight spiral. That was basically a duck. It hung up there, and it just was short. A
little bit of contact with the defender Eric Plett on that play, but that was more Klukas initiating as he came back to the ball, so no flag. Second down and 10, Sinegra with the snap, has time again, launches over the middle, and I'm not sure who this one was to. The closest guy was halfback Jaden McCoy. And the Dinos, all of a sudden, the offense on the last two series, a fumble and a two and out.
Again, a little crossing route there by the slot back Zindani. He was open over the middle, but I don't know if this wind now is causing Adam Sinegra a little bit of problem there. Zindani was open there over the middle between the hashes, but the ball sails on Sinegra, and a great 1-2 out for that Bison defense and that whole Bison football team that's got some great momentum right now, Dave.
And Nico DeFonte averaging 41.3 yards a punt. Really getting some strength in that leg. His average from last year on punts up by about 7 yards. Waiting for this one at his own 50 is Shea Ross. DeFonte drives it right, gets some good hang time at midfield. Settling under it, eluding the first batch of tackles, but going down just over the midfield stripe is Shea Ross.
Again, Shea Ross very shifty. There was about four Dinos all in their lanes there, but little juke and jive in there. He was able to split a couple of them and still get two or three positive yards there. And the Bisons, Dave, are starting in great field position here on the Dinos' side of the field. And if they can keep this momentum going, it's just going to build their confidence.
And that offense running out onto the field with a lot of energy, and why not? They've turned the tide of this game. Two drives ending in a field goal and a touchdown. Splitting off wide to the right, Kyle Patchell. Three receivers on that wide side of the field for Cattellier. Handoff inside, driving ahead down to about the 51-yard line, Jamel Lyles.
Again, Manitoba bringing in their fullback or H-back. That just a basic old-fashioned lead play that time where the fullback leads Lyles up the hole, but the Dinos do a nice job. Their interior linemen fill the gaps. The linebackers are free, and they clean up, stuff the play, and limit Lyles to a two-yard gain.
Second and seven, Jesse Walker checks back in at slot. He splits out to the left along with Shea Ross. Lining up deep to get that good running start. Empty backfield now for Cattellier. Cattellier under pressure, lobs one up, and we have got a flag. This is going to be pass interference on the Dinos. Looked like Michael Schmidt got tangled up.
Again, the Dinos sending the house, hoping that they're going to get the Cattellier before he can read the hot. Cattellier sees it, lays it up. I feel Schmidt wasn't confident that he had the proper positioning on that receiver for Manitoba. I believe it was Patchell. Patchell had a step, so Schmidt grabbed him, Dave, and it looks like the Dinos are going to get called for pass interference.
Well, legal contact. Defense, number 13. It's a 10-yard penalty. First down.
So the Dinos on that penalty had a chance to get off the field. Instead, they extend the drive. Manitoba taking over with a new set of downs at the 42-yard line. 2:42 to go in the first quarter. Manitoba with a 10-8 lead. Empty backfield again, all kinds of time. Looking over the middle, and this one is intercepted by the Dinos at the 28-yard line. And that looked like Michael Schmidt making up for that penalty on the last play.
And again, here Des Cattellier has been playing a really fine game up until that point there when he made a huge mistake, Dave. He did a nice job of getting away from the pressure. He had a lot of green grass in front of him. Again, Dave, he tried to force it into triple coverage that time, and the only guys that had the opportunity to catch that football were the Dinos. Again, a mistake here by Cattellier forcing that football. Had he run and even slid, he would have got some positive yards.
So the Dinos catch a break here. They take over first and 10 with 2:13 to go. Back at their own 27-yard line on the near hash mark. Handoff to Bobby Stewart. Stewart tries to bounce it off the right-hand side of the line, and he is buried under a wall of Bisons.
Again, the Dinos in that double tight end set, Dave, running a counter back to the short side of the field there where the running back starts to the wide, comes back to the short side. Initially, there was a gap, but the outside linebacker there was sitting at home. Defoe, nobody blocking him, nobody kicking him out, and he was able to trip up Robbie Stewart for a short three-yard gain.
Richard Sandani wide left, Michael Klukas wide right for the Dinos on second down. Sinagra in the pocket, completes, and that is Hunter Carl. He's out of bounds, just past the 40-yard line. That'll be a first down, Dinos.
Again, Hunter Carl, a product out of Centennial High School, just lighting it up here the last two, 3 years, coming into his own. Just basically goes 2 yards past the first down marker, breaks it out, settles down in a nice space between the numbers and the sidelines there, and Adam Sinagra throws him a strike for a first down.
First down again. There's the handoff to Stewart. Inside, straight up the middle, tripped up as he goes over the Dinos' 50-yard line, and he should have another first down.
Again, Robbie Stewart, a different type of runner than Jeshron Antwiet. He's a slasher. He's a power runner. He sees the hole. He takes that side step, and once he sees the gap, he fires in there. He's a big body, gets those shoulder pads low, and he has a great run, Dave, of 8 yards.
And this is going to be close. Didn't get that great of a spot, just over the 50-yard line. If he makes it, it won't be by much. If he's short, it won't be by much. And they stretch it out, and by the white stripe on the football, it is a Dinos first down.
Again, Robbie Stewart may not have that turbo speed, Dave, but he's quick enough. He's very powerful. He runs north-south, and that's what he did that time. Saw the seam, hit it, got low, got that great body lean, Dave. And because of that body lean, he was able to get the first down.
Yeah, this is the kind of drive that the Dinos needed. After a couple of tough turns with the ball, again, just a little bit of possession. Just try to find their rhythm. Get that mojo back. Sinagra Stewart releases out of the backfield, down the far sideline, looking for Michael Klukas just outside of his reach.
Again, Adam Sinagra going with a little pump and go there. He pumps it to the short underneath route, which you're hoping to catch defenders looking at the quarterback. Klukas does a little stutter step, gets actually behind the corner there on the right side of the field. We talked about how Adam Sinagra had the nice arc. That time, pass was a little shallow, and Adam Klukas wasn't able to run underneath it.
Linebacker Brody Williams checks in on second down. Bisons go with the three-man front on a passing down. Three receivers in motion to the left. That's where Sinagra's looking, has time again. Back over the middle and in traffic. I think that's Hunter Carl able to pull it in down at the 45-yard line.
Again, Adam Sinagra pulling a Brett Favre that time. Sits in the pocket, threads the needle in the triple coverage. Hunter Carl catches the pass. Again, Sinagra, great arm strength, but it looks like it's coming back, Dave, on a hold.
Holding the offense, number 61. It's a 10-yard penalty. Still second down.
And that is Curtis Cron getting the holding penalty. That's too bad because that was just a great show of confidence between a quarterback and a receiver.
Again, Hunter Carl had a step, and it was a tight window because the left linebacker was only a yard away from Carl. Sinagra, again, threaded that needle, but unfortunately a holding brings it back.
Second and 20. Sinagra stepping up into the pocket. Evades the rush, has a man over the middle, and that is complete at about the 47-yard line, and that was Michael Klukas able to catch that. Moves the chains.
Again, Adam Sinagra, very calm back there, Dave. He's getting time, but he's not panicking, Dave. He was able to shift to his left, get away from the pressure, buy himself some more time. Michael Klukas works his way to the middle, gets open for his quarterback, and a great second and 20 first down conversion.
And Klukas helping out his quarterback, just found a seam between two defenders. First and 10 for the Dinos, zeros on the clock. Last play of the quarter, handoff to Stewart. Stewart goes into the line, not much of anything there. He'll have a yard, maybe a yard and a half.
Again, that time, the right defensive end for the Bisons, Dave, blows up the block of the H-back. I believe it's Jack McDonald. He crosses Jack McDonald's face on that play. Jack McDonald's got to get the seal on that defensive end. He wasn't able to. The defensive end crosses the H-back's face. He's able to trip up Robbie Stewart right at the line of scrimmage.
Dinos are on the move. The Bisons have the lead, though, through 15 minutes at McMahon Stadium. It's the University of Manitoba 10, University of Calgary 8. You're watching Dinos football on Canada West TV.
A little bit of attention deficit disorder, but that's okay. All right, Megan, tell me a little bit about this project and Positive Match and what you guys all do.
So Positive Match is a 100% volunteer-run organization. And we are not for profit. We rescue dogs from Alberta, Saskatchewan, Manitoba, and we have international partners. And currently we just started partnering with the Dinos, and we have some of the players coming to the shelter to volunteer with us.
Fantastic, and Drew's really excited too by the looks of things. Tell us a little bit about Drew and what he's all about.
So Drew's about 1 year old, and he is such an adorable dog. He loves all people, all dogs, and would do best in a home with kids 5 or older.
I was just going to say, what's the perfect home for Drew in case somebody's going, you know what, I want that dog and I want it right now?
Yeah, so Drew was a stray found east of Calgary, and he was doing really well outside, but with winter coming, they were concerned about him being outside. So we got a call, and he's done well with everyone and in every house so far, so he would be good with almost anyone.
Any kinds of tricks he knows other than following football and wanting to be on the field with the boys right now?
Drew is still pretty young, so he's still learning some manners, but he loves to cuddle and he's super active.
As witnessed right here, he's super active and really like raring to go. As far as Positive Match is concerned, what are you guys looking for as far as people? Are you guys looking for volunteers? How do people get involved with you guys?
We're always looking for volunteers, and there's different ways you can volunteer. we're always looking for volunteers at the shelter or to foster animals, and we always want volunteers at events. You can check out our website, positivematch.org, to find out more, and we have an informational booth on the concourse today.
Fantastic. So if you haven't already, go check out Positive Match up on the concourse. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Megan Rosalie.
Second quarter just about to get underway at McMahon Stadium. The Manitoba Bisons with a surprising 10-8 lead over the Calgary Dinos. Dave Rowe and Tony Spallatini bringing you the action on a beautiful October afternoon in Calgary. Taking a quick look at some of the stat lines from the first quarter. Descatellier, 5 of 7 with an interception. He does have 70 yards passing in the one touchdown pass. Rushing, Jamel Lyles, as you'd expect, leading, 5 carries, 22 yards, but now it's the Dinos, 1st and 10 at the 45 of Manitoba. Sinagra with time, looking for Klukas deep. Klukas wide open, touchdown, Dinos!
Again, Dave, just the flat-out speed of Michael Klukas. Gets 3 yards behind the Manitoba corner, and Adam Sinagra just shows you the power of his arm, throwing a beautiful strike into that wind. And again, great pitch and catch there by the Dinos to regain the lead, Dave.
And Klukas, his second catch of the day. His 7th touchdown on the year. Adam Sinagra now 7 of 10 with an interception and a touchdown.
And again, Dave, on top of that beautiful drive, Dave, they gave their defense a big rest, especially after that turnover where Manitoba scored and got the ball back right away. Dinos come back, show some character, give their defense a big rest, and punch in the major here.
And just before the quarter, you have to remember that big third down conversion with Michael Klukas making his first catch of the game. Sinagra coming out of the pocket, Klukas coming back to help his quarterback. And those two hook up early and put the Dinos back on top, 15 to 10. Another look at the touchdown, and just a straight horse race as Michael Klukas runs away from the defender. That was Eric Plett for Manitoba.
Again, Eric Plett caught flat-footed. Dave, Michael Klukas was just blowing by him. It was a good 3 yards. He got in behind him there. Adam Sinagra, beautiful strike. Just Klukas doesn't even have to break stride. Again, great pitch and catch there by the quarterback. But that's how explosive that Dino offense is. You got Klukas, you have Carl, you've got Zindani, you've got that multitude of running backs. So again, a lot of weapons there for Adam Sinagra. And again, that offensive line with two young tackles giving him time to make the throws.
Walker and Ross back deep for Manitoba. And the ball rolls off the tee. Time for a quick scoring recap. A minute 27, at zeros on the clock. Nico DeFonte had an 85-yard single on the opening kickoff of the game. The Dinos followed that up. 4 minutes in as Hunter Carl hauled in a 15-yard pass from Adam Sinagra to make it 8-0. Brad Mikuloff with a 41-yard field goal to make it 8-3. And then off the fumble, Manitoba, Jesse Walker with a 20-yard touchdown pass from Descatellier, 10-8. And now Michael Klukas with a touchdown catch to open the second quarter, making it 15-10. And that ball goes over the head of Jesse Walker into the end zone. He'll take a knee to make it 16-10.
Again, Walker giving up the single to get the ball out to the 35 rather than in amateur football, Dave, if you attempt to make a return and you get past the goal line, it goes out to the 20. Whether you're down 15 or 16, isn't 5 or 6 points.
Still a one-score game.
Exactly, bud. So get the better field position. That's a very heads-up football play by Walker.
Again, Descatellier, 5 of 7, 70 yards, 1 touchdown, 1 interception for the St. Francis product. Sets up with Jamel Lyles in the backfield. They bring a slot back across the line to block. And Lyles is going to move the pile up close to the 40-yard line, a gain of about 5 yards.
Again, that slot back with that jet sweep motion there freezes the linebackers. It allows the offensive linemen of Manitoba to get to that second level because they've got to respect that potential of giving that slot back sweep there that time. Lyles gets a nice crease and gets a solid 7-yard gain on that dive, Dave.
Second down. Again, Jamel Lyles, all-purpose yards, 886 coming into this game. A real weapon in all three phases. Catelier, as the pocket collapses, finds a man over the middle, and that is complete. Down to the Dinos, 51-yard line, Stephen Ugba.
Again, great job by Catelier, standing in there, as you stated, the pocket collapsing around him, Ogba, just on a crossing route, was able to get underneath the safety and behind the linebackers. Cotillier throws a strike, pressure in his face for a huge first down.
And on the replay, just good concentration by Ogba on the catch. Manitoba down to the 51-yard line of the Dinos, and there's the handoff, and caught in the backfield is Jamel Lyles. He just got smothered.
Again, Boston Road just coming clean on an inside gap blitz that time, unblocked, and basically almost gets the football the same time Lyles does. They have their big H-back in looking for that lead run again, but nobody picks up Boston Road, comes through clean, trips up Lyles, and it looks like Cotillier might even be a little shaken up here, Dave.
Yeah, he is down on the field. Didn't see any contact.
Maybe Boston Road, Dave, I think, maybe after he made the tackle, as they went flying, him and Lyles, they might have fallen onto Cotillier's legs.
Well, the trainer. Yeah, well, let's see if we can get on the replay here. And it looks like Cotillier just kind of got maybe rolled up by Boston Row.
Again, he did get rolled up by Boston Row, Dave. Like, Boston Row was like he was shot out of a cannon. It's nice to see Cotillier now walking off on his own steam there. But yeah, Boston Row just came flying in there like Superman, knocked Lyles down, and then actually flew into Cotillier like dominoes.
Yeah, Cotillier kind of limping off the field. Looks like a left quad or a left groin injury. Theo Dizar, who was the starter at the beginning of the year, we've got a better angle on it. So you see the replay, and oh yeah, he just got hit by the Dino player, so a bit of a sore quad. So Dizar launches it over the middle, has a man complete, down to the 30-yard line, spin move by Jesse Walker as he takes the pile down to the 30. There is a flag in the backfield.
Again, Dizar, we know his forte is getting the ball downfield vertically. He does that beautiful strike along the hash that time to his inside receiver, Dave, but it looks like it's going back on a holding.
We're holding on the offense, number 55. It's a 10-yard penalty, still second up.
And again, that was just a great throw by Dizar, Dave. There was the halfback for the Dinos, stride for stride with the Manitoba slotback with the safety Schmidt over top, and Dizar just dropped it in between the two defenders, but all for naught as it goes back on a holding.
And that is Reed McMorris, left guard, guilty as charged. Second down, and it looks like about 25. Oh, the Dinos jump here. This is gonna be a free play for Dizar. Launches it over towards the near sideline, has a man complete on the Dinos, 47. Macho Bokru hauled it in, but I think the Dinos were offside on this.
Again, great job by Theo Dizar, changing up the cadence there. New quarterback, gets the Dinos to jump offside. As you stated, it's a free play, Dave, but they're still short by about 7 yards. So it'd be like 3rd and 7. I think you got to take the penalty and go for another shot for the first down.
And that looks like what the indication is going to be. There's a bit of hesitation on the part of really everybody on the field. With the way the Dinos jumped, Dizar almost looked like he was waiting for the play to be blown dead. Didn't hear a whistle. Launched the ball downfield.
On the defense. That penalty's declined. Third down.
But they do decline the penalty, so they're going to set up a third down. And this looks to be about 6 yards. At the 47-yard line. And the punt team is coming in on the field. I really don't get this.
Yeah, I don't get it either, Dave. I mean, maybe they're playing the field position game here, Dave, trying to, you know, pin the Dinos deep. I like the momentum that the Manitoba offense has, Dave, and I'd almost like to take another crack at a first down.
Yeah, this is one of those things that make you go, is Jacob Esquerdo is back for this. I think we'd expect Matt Riley to try and cough and corner this. And the Dinos do have the wind at their back here in the second quarter. And again, 12-19 to go and a 16-10 lead.
The only thing I'm thinking, Dave, is they're kicking into the wind. Maybe they want more positive yards while they're punting. But again, I would have tried another crack at a first down.
Oh, and contacting the kicker. And this one is going to give Manitoba a first down.
No question.
I believe that was Brett Wade coming up the middle, ran right into Matt Riley. Riley down on the field, selling hard.
Again, Dave, discipline. Brett Wade coming clean. Again, you're taught, Dave, to come across the foot of the kicker, not at the kicker.
Defense number 92. It's a 15-yard penalty.
Check that. That was 92. Jacob Plamondon.
I guess the young defensive lineman from Notre Dame Red Deer that time, a big talent here for the Dinos. Little excited, Dave. Doesn't come across the face of the kicker. He comes right at the kicker. You are taught to aim for the point in front of the kicker's foot, and that way, if you happen to miss, Dave, you don't hit the kicker. That time, he was too vertical, ran right into the kicker, and he extends the drive here for the Bisons.
And Matt Riley, the punter, is still down on the field now, just getting helped up to his feet.
Again, it's good to see that great young football player get up there and make his way to the sidelines.
So a teachable moment for Jacob Plamondon as he goes to the sidelines. Again, came as a free runner. And you're coming in like that, you're a young player, and you just all you see is the kicker and an opportunity to make a play, but you got to come in under control.
You got to come in under control, Dave, and you got to boomerang it, but you got to come across in front of the foot, not at the kicker.
And Taylor Altilio, the special teams coordinator, will be having a word with him, no doubt. Catelier back in the game, hands off to the inside to Jamel Lyles, and Lyles able to take it down to the 25, gain of about 7.
Again, that little counter, this time he steps to the short side and then breaks it back to the wide side. There was a nice big hole there between the right guards there, Clarkson and the tackle Williams for Manitoba. Lyles with that explosive speed shoots up the hole and gets a solid 5-yard gain.
Bisons with a real rotation in their receiving corps. Kyle Patchell checking in that time for Jesse Walker. Second down and short. Play action. Looking over the middle into the end zone. Has a man just out of his reach.
And again, that just a great matchup that time. I believe for Manitoba.
Steven Ugba
with great speed was able to get behind. I believe it was the young defensive back, Kant. Or Lucician, the coach Rapini there subbing in some young guys due to injury. Ugba was able to get a couple steps on that young Dino defensive back, but Des Catelier into that wind just wasn't able to get enough on that pass, and it came up a little bit short.
And Brad Nikoloff was good from 41 yards in the first half. He's going to try this from 32 yards straight on. With that breeze in his face, and it looked like Manitoba jumped. I just saw the Dinos pointing at that Manitoba offensive line. Again, this is going to push it back 5 yards.
This is kind of odd, Dave, when the defense gets the offense to jump there. A couple of stutter steps there by the Dinos on the front line there. Somebody twitched on the Manitoba O-line, and they're going to actually attempt that kick a little bit deeper into that win.
Yeah, Manitoba, 4 penalties on the day so far. So this now becomes a 37-yard attempt straight on into the wind. Dinos look like they're going to try and come after this one. And again, they contact the kicker one more time. And that was Adam Lorenz, the veteran defensive back, as this one is missed. Right out of the end zone by the Dinos, but this one is going to be a first down, and this drive is going to continue for the Bisons. 2 running into the kicking penalties. Let's look at that again.
Again, Dave, we're talking discipline here. You can't come at the kicker. You've got to come across the kicker. You've got to bend that, and Lorenz, again, doesn't bend it enough and ends up diving right at the kicker's legs.
And Adam Lorenz, again, a veteran that should know better. Calgary Stampeders draft 3. Pick traded at the Saskatchewan Rough Riders in this season. So first and 10. So the Bisons, for the second time, this drive is extended by a penalty. 10:29 to go.
Now is Lorenz.
Dinos with a 6-point lead, but the Bisons inside the red zone.
Again, is Lorenz arguing that he got a piece of the ball? I don't think he did, Dave.
And nope.
You know, again, these are just basic coaching points. One was a freshman, this one done by a senior. So, I mean, a special team coach, Taylor Altilio, is going to have to go over that block angle.
Shea Ross setting up at slot back right. Jamel Lyles in the backfield, first to 10 from the 16. Toss to Lyles, he looks at the right-hand side, and the Dinos able to penetrate for a 3-yard loss.
Again, that time, Corey Robinson reading that, he swims the right guard and slants right in front of where Lyles wants to cut back, trips him up and turns him into a host of other Dino defenders, and that causes Lyles to get a 2-yard loss.
And Corey Robinson, 5 tackles for loss. You can make that 6 now. They push it back 3 yards. Second down and 13 from Dino 19-yard line. Whatever. Inside 10, 9.5 minutes to go.
Whatever happens here, Dave, the Bisons are chewing up a lot of clock.
Under pressure, swings it out to Lyles, coming out of the backfield, makes one man miss. The second Dino defender able to bring that down. And that looked like Adam Lorenz coming in, able to stop this one short. So again, for the third time this drive, the Bisons come on to kick. And if I'm the Dinos, I just let him go right ahead and kick it. Stand there, here you go.
That time, Dave, Cyril Wannabe, the short side linebacker, just does a beautiful job. I mean, Jamal Lyles, one-on-one in open space is a difficult task. He broke down nicely, tripped him up, and then the cleanup by Adam Lorenz forcing Manitoba to kick the field goal.
We'll see if third time is the charm here for Brad Mikuluf. This time he's going to be trying it from 23 on the near hash mark. And he has missed it to the right, and it goes right through the end zone.
Again, I think there's a bit of a swirl to that wind, Dave. I mean, you can see it kind of hung up, and then it just faded like a slice, you know, and it just missed the outside of the left goalpost there, Dave. So that wind is playing some tricks down there.
There's some crazy stuff happening out here. The Dinos extend the drive twice on running into the kicker penalties. And then facing the shortest kick of that drive, Mikuluf just pushes it right. Single point up on the board to make it 16-11 as the Dinos take over. First to 10, 8:40 to go. Hand off on the inside. No, Sinagra rolls right. Now he's going to tuck it away and run. Strings it out to the sideline. Cuts it up. Out of bounds by the Manitoba bench at the 45-yard line. He'll have about 9, 10 yards. He's going to be close.
Again, those are one of those read option plays, Dave, where you have an option as the quarterback to either hand the ball off, pull it, and throw it. That time, Adam Sinagra didn't like the run decision. He pulls it. He's able to get outside. Nobody's open. His receivers do a nice job of stock blocking downfield, and Sinagra gets 9 yards, close to a first down gain on that scramble.
And he's a good running quarterback. He averages just over 11 yards per carry when he does take off with the ball. Second down and a couple of chain links. There's a handoff to Robbie Stewart inside. He just drives straight ahead, spins the pile to the 50 for a Dino first down.
Again, what I like about this, Dave, is when you've got less than a yard, right, get the first down, right?
Yep.
Don't try and look for the big play here. Robbie Stewart sees that. It's that stretch play. They got the whole line stretching to the left. Robbie Stewart feels it, comes to the short side right, lowers the shoulders, and gets a first down.
Sinagra, straight drop, empty backfield over the middle, has a man complete. That is Michael Klukas down to the 41-yard line.
Again, the Dinos exploiting the nice little hole here, Dave, in between the linebackers and the safety that time. They got Michael Klukas with that speed. They're giving him a big cushion, and what he's doing is he's running down about 10 yards and breaking it towards the middle and just settling down between the numbers and the hash, and Adam Sinagra is hitting him right on the numbers there. Great, great throw and catch.
Inside 8 minutes to the half now. Dino set up with that double tight end look. Hand off to Stewart. Check that, Jeshurun Antwi, and a flag comes in, and Antwi turns it up, has first down yardage inside the 30, but let's see what this flag is.
Looks like it's going to be holding there, Dave. That time, Robbie Stewart showing you that he has enough speed to get outside. He was able to get around the corner that time, and then he lowers the shoulder, and it looks like he might have knocked a big pop into the Manitoba defensive back there that time, Dave, and he's coming off the field, number 9, Platt, I stand corrected, and he's going to be looked at there maybe for concussion protocol, because Robbie Stewart really stepped into him and exploded through him before he went out of bounds.
Yeah, he looks a little dazed as he's had a seat on the sidelines. You can hear that impact up here. So with the holding penalty, it's back to the 51-yard line. It's going to be second down and 20. Sinagra with the empty backfield, over the middle, has a man complete. Brendan Theroux-Plamondon, he turns the corner at the 45, looking for that, the original line of scrimmage marker. So it's going to be second down and about 11.
Glenn, Plamondon, he slopped back to the short side of the field on the right, just comes across on a crossing route. Plamondon's about 220 pounds and extremely fast. He's a big load that time, hits him in stride, turns a corner, and gets just a little under half of the yardage back, Dave.
His 12th catch of the season, going to get him up around 140 yards receiving on the season. Did miss a game with an injury earlier this year. Second down. Sinagra over the middle again, has a man, and Sedani just couldn't catch up to that ball. He had his man beat over the middle. That was Shea Weeks on the defense.
Again, Sedani got inside position on Weeks there on a post route. Sinagra just wasn't able to get enough air on that time. That time, Manitoba sent some pressure. I think Sinagra felt it, even though initially it was picked up, probably let that go a little bit sooner than he wanted to, and just wasn't able to get enough air on that. And that could have been six had he been able to just get it up a little higher and allows Zindani to run underneath it.
Don't know if it's a straight speed match or if it's just good route running, but the Dinos have been able to get in behind these Manitoba defenders.
Well, the Dinos, Dave, do such a good job of getting vertical with their speed that once they stretch them, seam, they're able to juke and then get that inside position.
49-yard attempt for Defonte, and he is going to miss this one wide left, but it is going to go over the head of Jamel Lyles for a single point with 6:31 to go, so that'll make it 17-11. Get the Dinos that six-point bulge back. At the distance, just missed it.
Again, didn't look like he got a clean, you say, Dave, a good swing on that time. Looked like he knuckleballed it a bit, and it just kind of hooked to the left.
And Nico Defonte, his longest on the year, a 48-yarder. Timeout down on the field. I think if you're Brian Doby, you have to be pretty happy with the way this game is going for you. You're hanging in with the number two team in the nation, the top team in Canada West. You've had some opportunities to score.
Well, basically, Dave, they're playing their game plan to a T. And, I mean, it doesn't hurt when Dino undisciplined penalties extend some drives for you. But if you look at the stats, the offenses are equal. You got 185 yards for the Dinos, 150 for the Bisons. The Bisons are doing exactly what they need to do. They're chewing up the clock. They're keeping the Dino offense off the field. And so far, Dave, they're within striking distance. The longer they can keep this game close, the more they're going to believe that they're going to pull an upset.
And Descatellier, other than that one interception that he threw, which is the kind of thing that you're going to see out of a guy in only his third start, I think he's showing good poise back there in the pocket.
There's no question. And I mean, and the Dinos have been bringing the heat, Dave. And he's been standing in there. And you said it more than once in this first half. He's been taking a pounding. But again, Dave, when you take that shot and you make a big completion, it doesn't hurt as much.
For the Dinos, Adam Sinagra, he's been able to make good use of his main weapons. The guys like Jeshrin Antri, Hunter Carl, and Michael Klukas having a good game. You've got those two receivers that are in the top five in the nation in receiving.
Well, exactly. Those guys are explosive. But then you've got the talent like Zindani, who's got speed inside that you can go to. Then you can check down to your running backs, who are also good receivers, or Thera Plamondon, who's a big body there at the slot back position. So Sinagra has a lot of weapons that he can turn to.
After the miss, the Bisons take over, first and 10 from the 42-yard line with 6.5 minutes to go until the half. They trail 17-11. Under pressure, and down goes Catelier. Looked like he was trying to hang in until the last second, but just could not escape that pass rush.
Again, he was looking for Ross on the short side of the field here to the left on a quick slant route. Had him initially, didn't want to pull the trigger, and then when he pulled it back, Dave, the pressure got to him. Ross initially got inside position, was open. He didn't pull the trigger, and then that dino pressure from the right end was able to get to him.
Yeah, right end pressure, just pushing his man back to get the sack. Second down and 19 after the sack. Three receivers in motion right. Catelier gets it away. A wobbler just before he gets hit. This one is out of bounds over the Manitoba sideline and intended for Shea Ross. And again, another shot on Catelier just as he got that ball away.
Again, Catelier had no choice, Dave, just to put that on the sideline. Adam Lorenz did a nice job of covering over top. That time they had a little bit of bracket, they call it, where you have one defender underneath and one over top. Adam Lorenz was the over top defender. He did a nice job coming over there. Had Catelier kept that more in bounds, Adam Lorenz would have had an interception. Catelier did the good thing. He put it where only his guy could get it or nobody.
Dean Leonard, the son of Stampeder Kenton Leonard. And Esquerdo, Jacob Esquerdo, the son of JP Esquerdo, waiting for this punt. And Riley back in after he was shaken up. Doesn't really get good distance on it. Taken by Esquerdo at the 45-yard line, looking for somewhere to go. And he just runs into the big white and brown pile. They're about to return of maybe 2 yards. Just want to go back to Dean Leonard for a second. Got a look at him the last time out in that win over Saskatchewan. He had a kick return for a touchdown. You talked about the explosive speed. I was talking with Marcello Rapini, the defensive backs coach, and he said he really had to get Dean Leonard to use that speed. He said he was so used in high school to being able to go at half speed and just be that much better than everybody else. You can't do that at this level. And a few games into the season, he really started to see Leonard taking advantage of that gift.
Well, there's no question. And that's what it takes when you get to the next level. But everybody is fast up here. And if you're fortunate enough to go pro, they're even faster yet. So these young guys are getting baptized here. And that's what's amazing about this program, is to maintain that number two status and still play a lot of freshmen.
First and 10, Dinos at the 35-yard line, just over 5 minutes to go. Dinos with a 17-11 lead. Sinegra with the top of the pocket, looking deep downfield for Klukas, and this one is intercepted. Marcel Arunda-Welch getting under it. He takes it back to the 45, close to the 50-yard line before he gets taken down. And again, that ball just looked like it was underthrown.
Again, that was outstanding coverage that time by the corner of the Bisons. Stride for stride with Klukas. Klukas didn't have any position on him, and that ball hung up. Sinegra not able to step into it and get enough on it, and it just was short. It was great coverage and a big turnover here for the Bisons.
First interception on the day for Sinegra, and that is his fifth of the year. Bisons take over first and 10 from their 47-yard line. Cattellier looks towards the sidelines. It just misses his man, incomplete for Jesse Walker.
Again, that was just man coverage. Boston Rowe on the explosive Walker. The middle linebacker, Boston Rowe, was stride for stride with Walker that time. And Cattellier had no choice but to either put it outside or interception that time. And he puts it outside, and it's incomplete.
4.5 minutes to go before the half, second and 10. For the Bison, Shea Ross splits off to the left, short side of the field. Now collapsing into the left side of the line and breaks in over the middle. Has a man complete out of the backfield. Lyles outruns his man, but a shoestring tackle at the 50-yard line allows Lyles to fall forward to the 45 and a Bison first down.
Again, you'll take this matchup anytime. You've got Jamil Lyles on Mika Tights. Now, Mika Tights is a great athlete and he's quick, but nowhere near as fast as Jamil Lyles. Jamil Lyles comes out of the backfield. Mika Tights has to get out to the flat to cover him. Lyles, with that blazing speed, is just able to get open. Great throw by Cattellier and first down for the Bisons.
Yeah, with the shoestring, though, that stopped a much bigger gain. Dino, 45-yard line, first and 10 for the Bisons. And a little delay, handoff to Lyles up the middle. He's got some room, breaks one tackle, gets down to the 35-yard line, should have another Manitoba first down.
Again, just a beautiful draw play that time. Great play calling here by the Bisons. Cattellier drops back like he's going to throw, and then at the last minute puts the ball in the breadbasket of Lyles. The middle of that field opened up like the Red Sea there, and a huge run for Lyles.
Adam Lorenz able to get over and make the tackle. Again, great job by the Manitoba offensive line. Just push that Dino pass rush to the outside and open up that big hole. It is going to be second down and a couple of chain links. And Dizar tries the left-hand side of the line, and he's able to elude Corey Robinson just long enough to gain a yard or two and a first down.
Again, Corey Robinson comes through on block, but Theo Dizar is a load.
That guy's a load.
He's
that
a load.
A
like
lot
he's,
of
he's 6'4", 220-plus, and he basically drags Corey Robinson for the first down again. Great, great QB to have running your short yardage plays, Dave.
Now 3:10 to go until the half. Manitoba trying to finish off a drive. They trail by 6, 17-11. Lyles in the backfield, receivers in motion right, handoff inside. This time, the Dinos able to get that penetration. I think that was Brett Wade who got through, and Lyles is still trying to move the pile, and the ball comes out. Manitoba able to recover. That looked like a rugby scrum down there.
Again, I'm surprised that the whistle didn't go. It looked like Corey Robinson flying off that left end was able to get a hand on Lyles. As you stated, Dave, it looked like a ruck where they were just rucking it down the field. A lot of times, Dave, when you don't blow the whistle like that, you got a tendency for guys to get hit or the ball getting stripped, as we just saw there.
Heads up play for Jesse Walker as the receiver got back into the pile and was able to pick up that ball as it came loose. So this gives the Bisons life. They're second down and nine at the Dino 34-yard line with 2:39 to go. Slot back cuts across the line, play action, looking at the near side, back over the middle, intercepted, Boston Rowe, and Rowe hands off the ball. Bit of a dangerous play there. The Dinos actually losing some yards on that. Boston Rowe, his third interception of the year, had a pick six against Saskatchewan a couple of weeks ago off a pass deflection, but again, just a bad read by Descatellier. Boston Rowe was right there.
And again, Dave, you had mentioned earlier the shots he's taken. Is it going to affect him? I think, you know, Dave, they're starting to now, because I think of all that pressure. He had no need, really, to let go of that football as soon as he did, but I think he felt the pressure that time. He had a defender right in front of him, and he forced that pass right into Boston Rowe. Now, Boston Rowe here, catch that football and go north-south. Don't try and go lateral and try and play option quarterback.
Yeah, really option that off to Michael Schmidt. There's the handoff to Robbie Stewart. Stewart met right at the line. He's going to be pushed back for a loss of a yard.
Again, Robbie Stewart that time, Dave, got again, predetermined that time where he was going to run. Looked like there was a nice push on the right side. He's had success going backside, and sometimes, Dave, when you have success going backside, you always want to go backside, even if you shouldn't. That time, there was nothing backside. He thought he was going to get open there again, and it was a great job by the short side of the Bison line to stuff Robbie Stewart for no gain.
Two interceptions now for Catelier as the Dinos escape. Man wide open down the field, and just out of the outstretched hands of Hunter Carl. And Carl can't believe it. He was wide open. He was 5 yards clear of the defender and just could not catch up with that ball. Third down, Dinos. Manitoba's going to get it back.
Again, that's where, if you're Adam Sinegra, you want that one back. I don't know if the wind, I think it looks like the wind must have taken this one here, because you can see Adam Sinegra wanted to put some touch on that. When you've got a guy 5 yards wide open, Dave, you just want to just drop that thing in there. And the wind kind of took that one and just over the outstretched fingers of Hunter Carl. That could have been six
and
for the
Dinos.
That
would have been his second touchdown of the day. Defonte is on to punt this one away. And that breeze is picking up. Now the goalposts are starting to move. We got a timeout by Manitoba. Jaden McCoy back to receive this punt. Yeah, look at that far goalpost. This wind has really picked up here in the last couple of minutes. Very unpredictable.
Again, Dave, you don't really want to fault Adam Sinegra on that pass. You could see he was trying to take a little bit off of it. I mean, the only thing he maybe could have done, Dave, was put a higher trajectory on that ball to allow him to kind of run underneath it, right? But I think you get excited. You see your guy that wide open. You want to get him that football as fast as you can. And maybe that lower trajectory, got the wind took it, and it just kind of sailed on him.
Shea Ross and Jaden McCoy going to wait for this one back at their 40-yard line.
Defonte can get his leg into this one, should be able to get some good distance here, and maybe they can win a little bit of field position on this drive, Dave.
Bisons will get the ball back. They're going to have about a minute and a half to work with. Defonte going to boot this one away from about his 15-yard line as he steps into it. Big hang time. Drifting back for it, taken at the 30-yard line. That is Shea Ross trying to turn it upfield. He'll get to the 31-yard line. It's going to be a long field for the Bisons with 1:28 to go.
Again, Searle wanna be on that tackle, Dave, but it's just a great job by the contain of the Dinos. Contain means you're the outside guy and you can't allow the returner to get outside you. And what they did that time, the right contain for the Dinos, kept Shea Ross inside, allowed Surawanabe and a couple other Dinos cover guys to corral him and make a great tackle. And Manitoba starting on the 31-yard line. So great field position exchange that time for the Dinos.
Going into this game, the Dinos with the fewest punts in the nation. They punted just 27 times before this one. Catelier wants a big yardage, puts up a 50-50 ball, and he gets a flag. And Michael Schmidt is going to get tagged for contacting Stephen Ugba.
Again, the Bisons are picking on the second-year defensive back, Lucician from Bishop Grandin High School there. Ugba was able to get inside position, Cotillier throws a strike into the wind. He was able to get it, but a great job that time by Ugba. He was able to get inside position on Lecition and then also shield Schmidt, who was playing over top from the football. Great throw and catch, and they also get an interference, but they're going to decline it because that was just a great throw and catch.
So about a 40-yard gain on that.
Pass interference. Defense, number
122 to go.
That penalty's declined. First down.
And Matthew Lecision getting the flag. I thought that might have been Michael Schmidt on the coverage.
Again, Coach Rapini having to go with some young halfbacks due to injuries, Dave, and the Bisons, as any good coaching staff would, picking on these young Dino defenders.
First and 10, the Bisons thinking a score before the half at the 45-yard line. And he has a man wide open, and that ball hangs up complete down at the 12-yard line to Jesse Walker. And I guess they're saying Walker was down by contact with Adam Lorenz.
And again, Jesse Walker, that explosive speed, right? He fakes that he's going vertical, then breaks it to the sidelines, gets 2-3 yards step ahead of Adam Lorenz. Beautiful the win by Gatillier, and another big first down for the Bisons.
And it must have seemed like that ball was taking forever to get to Jesse Walker as he was waiting for it to come down. First and 10 from the 13-yard line. Empty backfield, complete down by the 5-yard line. And we've had a quarterback switch. Dizar is back in at quarterback as he completes that one to Jesse Walker down to the 5-yard line.
Again, maybe it was, it's just a one play. Was it Dizar, the previous two plays, two days?
I'm not sure, but Dizar's in now, and you can see Cotelier. Maybe after that last interception, they just wanted to sit the young quarterback down and let him have a look.
Again, Stan corrected. That was Dizar who threw those previous two strikes because, again, he's big, he's strong, and he's got a powerful arm. And I could see him having the confidence to take those strikes into the wind.
Second down and 3 yards to go from the 5-yard line. 42 seconds on the game clock is all over the place. It went from 42 now to 47 seconds. And it looks like 47 is correct. Inside receivers in motion, right to left. Empty backfield for Dizar. Lobs it in the corner of the end zone. Wide open, knocked away by Adam Lorenz. Shea Ross was wide open. Lorenz came in and swatted it away.
Again, a great play call by the Bisons. Dino sending the house. Shea Ross was able to get behind the coverage, and Adam Lorenz is able to recover and just knock it out of his hands. Initially, it looked like Adam Lorenz was beat by a couple steps, but again, that football kind of hung up into the wind. It allowed Lorenz, and the veteran could read the receiver's eyes, saw when his hands were going up, and he swatted that football away, forcing the Bisons to kick a field goal, Dave.
One for two is Brad Mikuloff as he comes in for a 12-yard chip shot. No mistake that time to make it 17-14. But you contrast that with that ball hanging up with Adam Sinagra in the first quarter when he had Hunter Carl in the corner of the end zone. He put enough arm into that ball so that Carl was the only guy that had a chance to catch it. Lorenz beaten on the play, but that ball hung up long enough for him to get in there and punch it out.
Again, catch 22 for Dizar. If you don't put enough trajectory, you're going to hit Lorenz in the back of the head. You put a little too much, it hung up, right? You're damned if you do, damned if you don't. But Lorenz dodges a bullet there and just makes a great play of swatting it away at the last minute. The Dino defense there bends, doesn't break. But again, if you're Manitoba, you go in halftime, you're jacked. You're up on offense. You're up on, I'm sure, time of possession, Dave. You're controlling the game. You're dictating the game. I mean, they're in this game. That Dino offense, for the most part of the second quarter, has just lost their rhythm.
And the Dinos taking over with 32 seconds on the clock. It's like they're setting up to run at least one play. Sinagra with Jeshrin Antwi in the backfield. Justin Daziak, wide right, collapsing on the line. Delay handoff to Antwi. He's got some room to run. Takes it up to the 40, puts his head down. He'll have six.
Again, just similar to what the Bisons ran in the previous drive. Little draw play. Sinagra dropping back like he's going to throw. Hands it off to to Antwi as he does the pass fake, and Antwi gets a 7-yard gain up the middle.
Second down and three, 26 seconds on the clock. Sinagra with a quick drop and the quick strike to Klukas, and he steps out of bounds by the Dinos bench. It's going to be first down at the 50-yard line.
Again, Antwi getting a good solid 7 yards allows him to throw intermediate routes. That time, the corner for Manitoba, respecting the speed of Klukas, gives him a big cushion. Klukas breaks it out at 8 yards, gets the first down, but more importantly, gets out of bounds to stop the clock.
And you got about a 20-yard field to give Nico DeFonte a shot at a field goal. Over the middle, and that one is complete. That looks like Richardson Danny as he hauls it in down at the 46-yard line.
Again, just a nice little curl route by Zindani. He's on the right side. He's the inside receiver to the short side of the field on the right. He goes down the numbers and then just hooks up around the hashes, and Sinagra throws him a nice strike in between two defenders.
Timeout for the Dinos. 15 seconds on the clock. If you fire him off quick enough, you got a chance for, I'd say, maybe two plays before you bring in DeFonte for the field goal.
Again, it looks like Manitoba's playing a little bit of a prevent defense, Dave. I don't like that. I think I'm of the thought that you stay aggressive even when there's not a lot of time on the clock, because to me, prevent defense, it prevents you from being successful that time. When you go back into big cushions and that, you leave a lot of big holes. And when you've got explosive receivers like the Dinos and a solid quarterback like Adam Sinagra, he's able to move it down the field and get within field goal range. I think if you're Manitoba, man, you got to send some heat.
If you're Wayne Harris and Ryan Sheehan, the offensive coordinator, are you thinking field goal here, or do you maybe want to take one shot at the end zone?
I think, Dave, you think field goal. I think you get the field goal, Dave. You get that six-point lead again. You go into the locker room with something positive, right? You take that shot, Dave, and then it might, you might chew up too much time, which won't allow you to get closer for the field goal.
There goes Daziuk splitting off wide left. Short side of the field is Michael Klukas. Sinagra looking over the middle, has a man complete. Trying to get to the sideline and tripped up is Brandon Thera. He gets to the 41-yard line.
I think again, just a mistake that time by Thera, man. You gotta go north and south. North and south, okay? Get your shoulder pads upfield. You get tripped up. Don't worry about going out of bounds. Now they're gonna have
Clock's gonna stop anyway.
Exactly, right? You get upfield, they're gonna call a timeout anyway. You may have gotten another 10 yards. And now they're gonna have to try and throw a quick one out of bounds. Do they have another timeout? Yeah, I think the Dinos still. No, the Dinos have no more timeouts. So it looks like they're going to have to try a field goal from here now with 9 seconds.
Well, let's see what they do. They might try one quick one to the sideline just to gain a couple of yards. It'd be a 49-yarder from here. Nico DeFonte has hit from 50, and he does have the wind at his back. He did miss that long one earlier in this quarter, though. And Michael Klukas is coming in just to check on the play call. Jeshrin Antwi in the backfield. Dinos with a double tight end set. Sinagra with all kinds of time. Launching into the end zone. This one hangs up and it's knocked away by Manitoba. Still 1 second on the clock. And that was intended for Hunter Carl. That ball just hung up there too long.
Again, they must have read your mind, Dave. They want to take that shot into the end zone. That time, in the previous play, where he overthrew Hunter Carl. This time Hunter Carl got behind the defender again, and that one just didn't come clean, didn't get a good snap on the throw, but it wasn't a spiral, it was a duck. And and when you don't get that clean spiral, Dave, it just hangs up there.
Great coverage by Houston Rennie as he was able to get up there. He even had a chance to intercept that ball, but at least was able to knock it down. So DeFonte is gonna line this one up. Let's see where the knee goes down. Let's call this a 49-yard attempt, as Hunter Carl is ready to hold. And Jamel Lyles is back, so the Dinos are going to have to think about coverage on this. The kick is in the air, it's up, and it is good. So
again,
Dinos,
just a great kick by DeFonte, Dave.
That is his longest of the year at 49 yards with zeros on the clock. So the Dinos take the lead into the halftime, 20-14. You're watching the Dinos and the Manitoba Bisons on Canada West TV.
There's our on-field host, Joe McFarland, and the Dinos head coach, Wayne Harris. Joe, let's find out from Wayne what went on in the first half.
Absolutely, yeah. Wayne, tell us a little bit what you guys saw from a coaching staff perspective in that first half.
Well, certainly we knew it was going to be a big battle out here. You know, Manitoba's playing desperate. We're taking too many penalties right now. We got to clean that up. Offensively, we got to be more consistent. But, you know, it's what we expected.
A lot of penalties, as you mentioned. What's the message to the boys going into the room in terms of kind of toning things down, or is it just being a little cleaner?
Well, it's being a little cleaner. You know, the guys are playing really aggressive, and sometimes those aggressive situations, you take a penalty you don't want to, but we definitely got to do a better job in the second half.
Coach, thanks so much for this, and we'll see you in the second half. Good luck.
Jeshon Antwi, number 21, running back.
Michael Klukas, number 19, wide receiver.
Black and red jogging towards us?
I think so.
All right, I'll try it.
I believe you.
I believe you.
I believe you.
Tottenbang.
Sexual violence is any unwanted sexual attention or act against someone without their freely given consent.
One court on the field, boys. One court. Fuck.
I believe you.
Back here at field level, we are ready to go with another edition of Peer Pong. Over on this side, we have Erica and Emma. On this side, we've got Olivia and Mackenzie. And who did you guys decide who's actually going to shoot first? These guys are. All right, so it's Olivia and Mackenzie. They all shoot there, too. Those two will shoot there, too.
And they'll keep going back and forth, and it's up to you, fans, to be making some noise every time they shoot. And then we'll get a winner. We get some great prizes for all four. So whenever you guys are ready to go, toss away in the Dinos edition of Peer Pong. Yes, you did not hear that wrong. Right, oh, so close. Right off the bat, they're getting them. There's one. Oh, no. You gotta watch that. Watch that, my good young lady. We're gonna get some soap in the mouth. See, it wasn't that bad. Oh, so close again. See, the wind's not awful. Oh, you'll use too much mustard. There's too much mustard on that one. You just gotta dial it down a little. Close, but no cigar. And another one. I think we've got a ringer over here. I think you've done this before, haven't you? I knew I recognized you from somewhere. There you go. That counts. I'm giving her that one. Oh, tying it up. All at 4-4 now. Calgary, how you doing up there? We need a lot of noise in that second half. Get the boys the win. Keep things rolling for your Dinos. Close but no cigar. Big ups to our promotions team. You already got that one. I don't know if you got the memo. Wait, that one you already had. Back at it again. They've got some time. Short it up. Oh, basketball started. Just a little hop. Oh, that won't count because that didn't actually, it didn't enter. It didn't hit the bottom. Did not hit the bottom. I absolutely, that was not a no, that was a no-go. I'm calling. I called you. You got the call. You keep arguing, I'm going to give it to them. I like how they'll argue a point. You got, I told you, you got that one already. Oh, man. That one I'm going to give. That one went in the bottom and in. Yeah. Absolutely. That's what the referee is here for. It's rigged. You just got, you got to stop in the spot where you already got him. Okay, fine. See, like that one. That one's good. Got a nail biter going on. Too much. A little too much. Back at it again. It's swing right between the two. So close. Not close enough. You don't get it on the bounce, I'm sorry. Neither do you. The wind picked up just a little bit, I will say. You can't wait for the wind. This is Southern Alberta. That was more of a, like a fast pitch. Like usually it's a slow pitch kind of game. Like, close. Oh. That was less than stellar of me on that one. There we go, back at her again. There we go, that's there. Now we're tied again. And a little bit of a shimmy, a little selly right there. I like that. I want it. No, we won't try. Don't try that one again. Don't, no. Not on the knockout and on the bounce. No, unless you call your shot. That one was in. Down to their last one. Emma and Erica, gotta get it done. Close, you got those ones already. Now it's Olivia and McKenzie, they gotta get this last one. They get the win, for the win. No. I like the girls like, nope. That breeze just came up out of nowhere. All right, you guys got some chance for retribution here. Oh, so close. You're hitting it. You're just not getting it in there. I think they need a little bit more crowd noise. One of them says, they hate us. No, they don't. You're not hated. They just want you to win. That's all. They want you to save this basket. Yeah, no, it's not so much. Back at it again. Got a couple minutes to go. Oh, so close. Just so close, yet so far away. All right, for the W. It looked good. Looked really good. So much pressure here. Oh, I'm so close again. You guys are getting lives there. Erica and Emma, you guys getting lives. And you keep letting us down. I'm kidding. We love you. Man, that wind is just not helping you guys at all. We're going to give you guys three more chances each, like both ways, so you get three shots each. So we got to let the teams come back out at some point. God, there, just more muscle. More oof. Yo. That was enough oomph, just wide to the left, all right. There you go, there's one. It is down to this. So much excitement. She's trying to convince Mother Nature to stop with the wind. All right, down to the second last shots. Does with a smile. Yeah. Could it be? Might it be? It could not be. So close. Second last shots for Erica and Emma. Oh, I wish you guys were all, this is one of those moments where I wish that you guys were all mic'd up. All right, down to this. Could it be? No. Just walks away like a, not there. All right, one more shot here for the victory. I like that. No. One more. You got it. I lied. Bonus shots each. One more each. Last chance for the big W, and the fans need to go crazy. That wasn't something to go crazy about. But we got this. We got this. Oh, so close. Last shots. One more each, we got great prizes, I think. If we end up in a tie, we'll get prizes each way. We'll leave. A little less move than that, but still need a move. Nah. We gotta end it there, ladies and gentlemen, but we got prizes for all four. Please put your hands together, make some noise for Erica, Emma, Olivia, McKenzie, and make sure the boys can hear you in the room. Your University of Calgary Dinos!
I believe you.
I believe you.
I believe you.
Tôi tin bạn.
Sexual violence is any unwanted sexual attention or act against someone without their freely given consent.
I believe you.
I believe you.
I believe you.
We believe you.
Sexual violence is complex and can include many different things, from a violent sexual assault, verbal sexual harassment, sharing explicit pictures or video, offensive language, or stalking. I believe you.
I believe you.
Ami Bisheshpuri.
We believe you.
We believe you.
Sexual violence is never okay and is not tolerated at the University of Calgary.
I believe you.
I believe you.
I believe you.
We believe you.
Te creo.
If you think you've experienced sexual violence, we are here to help. And we believe you.
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 The middle. What a grab! Unbelievable!
He caught that?
He did! He pulled it in! Shy Ross! Backflip!
He will fake it and they'll go to the near side of the field. A hurtling move there.
Mitchell Picton to the right. Now Picton's in trouble and he escapes. Picton now running for his life, finds a man. That's complete. An opportunity to get it to the end zone, and they will. Touchdown, Atlee Simon. And what a play by the quarterback, Noah Picton, to keep that play alive.
And looked like he had two hands on him, but great strength and focus there to break free, still find his receiver, and then does a little bit of work after the catch. Third and two, it looks like, in there. Scrambling. Pass is picked off! It's picked off right at the goal line. And what a great job there by the Birds. That's Malcolm Lee. Malcolm Lee with a big pick. It's a touchdown saver for the Thunderbirds.
The line of scrimmage is the 25. Catelier rolling right, throws right, picked off.
That defender was able to drop off and get underneath that throw that went to the wideout towards the sidelines.
Pressured from behind, lost the ball, and it was scooped up. What a play by Nicholas Daly.
You see Daly, quick little dips the shoulder again, gets the hand around, and then as he's on the ground, scoops the ball. That's just a heck of a play.
Forced to kick it from his own 50, and this one is going to come down right at the Rams' goal line. And that one will be brought back up the field. Now trying to find a little bit of space on the near side. And he's got a little bit of room. And that'll be taken out of bounds. Matt Riley punts this one away from the Manitoba 28. Great kick that gets a good bounce and it rolls into the Alberta end zone.
Pinto breaking, a move up the middle, he's over the 40. Pinto, he's at midfield. Travell, he fumbled the football. He fumbled it, it looks like the Dinos have it. And as he breaks, we'll see where Boston Rowe comes. You're right about that, Brent. He lays the lumber on a nice low hit there to knock that ball loose.
Second half is just about to get underway here at McMahon Stadium as the teams return to the field. The Dinos leading the Manitoba Bisons 20-14. Thank you for spending your afternoon with us here on Canada West TV. Dave Rowe with the play-by-play, Tony Spalletini with the analysis, and let's look, Tony, at some highlights from that first half.
Here's a Dinos quarterback Adam Sinagra on that first touchdown strike to Hunter Carl. And again, with the wind blowing in his face, Sinagra able to get enough air under the ball where only Carl could get to it.
Well, exactly. Hunter Carl was able to get a stride behind the defender there. Sinagra puts a beautiful arc on it, just drops it into a bucket right into the breadbasket of Hunter Carl. It's a great first touchdown pass for the Dinos.
Fumble by Jeshurun Antwi there, and that was turned over by Donovan Gregoire, and that sets up a touchdown by Jesse Walker for the Manitoba Bisons.
Again, a beautiful throw there by the former St. Francis High School star Cotillier. He gets Walker just at the corner of the end zone with that explosive speed, was able to get a couple steps on the Dino defender.
Talk about explosive speed. How about the Dinos? Michael Klukas just able to blast the defender on that play, Eric Plett, for the big touchdown pass.
There you got Boston Rowe just knifing in. Not only does he take out the running back Lyles, but he manages to knock over Des Cotillier, and Cotillier then was able to get up and return into the game, Dave.
Bad series for the Dinos here as they're looking to get the ball back. First they run into the punter, then they run into the Bison's field goal kicker.
And again, a whole bunch of undisciplined play there by the Dinos in that second quarter that kept Bison drives alive. You just saw the punt, and now you're seeing them roughing the kicker on the field goals too.
And the Dinos caught Manitoba twitching there. That moved the ball back 5 yards, and then it was a bad miss for Brad Mikuluk, a chance to keep this game close for Manitoba.
Again, that poor miss there for Mikuluk was the wind. It was looked like it was going to go right in between the pipes, and that wind just sliced it to the far right.
Interception by Marcel Arruda-Welch there, kind of pushing off Richard Sindani. Manitoba with the ball back and an interception right back in Boston Rowe. Some interesting decision-making here as he goes backwards and laterals to Michael Schmidt, but that did snuff out a scoring drive by Manitoba.
And again, a little pressure there in Adam Sinagra's face. He lets go of it a little sooner than he would have liked to, and with that big wind behind him, it sails, and Hunter Carl wasn't able to make the big catch.
Trying to launch into the end zone. Great defensive play by Adam Lorenz here to knock the ball away. Manitoba had to settle for a field goal on that drive, and just before the half, Sinagra with a little bit of a wobbler. That one came up short, set up a 48-yard field goal by the Dinos to make it 20-14 as we get set to start the second half. They're trying to kick it off here, and the ball is blown off the tee a couple of times now for Brad Mikuluk. Out-of-town scoreboard, Regina leading Alberta 28-19. That game is at the half. Also later on tonight, UBC at Saskatchewan, a game with third place implications. UBC at 3-2, Saskatchewan at 2-3. So Jaden McCoy comes on to hold. Dean Leonard back deep, waiting for this one.
Let's go!
Line drive kick. Leonard's going to take it right at the goal line. Take it up between the hash marks and the numbers. Cut it outside. He gets to about the 20, where the Dinos will start first and 10.
Again, just a beautiful cover that time by the Bisons there on the left side of the line there. You got for the Bisons, you got number 26, Julian Lewis, just a backup linebacker, comes flying down, slips the wedge, and just tackles Dean Leonard before he can pick up any speed and turn that into a big run.
Adam Sinagra coming out, 12 of 20, 184 yards, two touchdowns, and one interception.
Again, both teams, Dave, in the first half, not able to establish running games.
And the Dinos try that again with Jeshurun Antwi, and he is going to get to the line of scrimmage and nowhere else. Robbie Stewart led the way for the Dinos. What running game there was, 5 carries for 25 yards. Jeshurun Antwi, 3 carries for 13 yards and a fumble in the first half.
Again, Antwi looking to get outside. He was turned back in by the defensive end, and then a nice tackle by Donovan Gregoire, the big middle linebacker for the Bisons.
Dinos deferred to get that wind advantage. So they start the ball with the ball in the second half, and that one is deflected. It was just slightly behind the intended receiver. I think that was Michael Klukas.
Dinos again looking for those little curls in the middle of the field there, Dave. That was Thera Plamondon coming across that one a little bit behind him. He wasn't able to settle down. It was kind of on his back shoulder there. He wasn't able to corral it, and it forced the Dinos to punt. Here, Manitoba defense doing their job, pinning the Dinos deep and forcing them to kick into that heavy wind.
And Nico DeFonte averaging, he's pretty much right on his season average here at 41 and a half yards a punt. Shea Ross back to receive this one at the Manitoba 50. See what DeFonte is able to do with this wind. Bit of a high snap. corrals it, kicks it over to the wide side, away from Ross, curls back. He takes it on the run, fumbles it, and a flag comes in, and Manitoba able to recover that ball on the Dino side of the field. A fortunate bounce, and I think they're going to get a no yards on top of this on that short kick.
You can see that football hung up there like a volleyball dead serve, you know. Defonte got some good leg into it, but once it reached its peak height, it just kind of hung there in the wind. And I think the returner for Manitoba, knowing that the Dinos weren't breaking down, took a chance thinking that he was going to get that no yards, Dave. He got lucky because he wasn't able to hang on to the football.
Did you see the way that ball curled back? Defonte was aiming it towards the far sideline, and it curled back inside the hash
exactly.
marks. So that wind is a big factor. So Manitoba, we're just waiting for this to get sorted out here, waiting for the call by the official.
We have no yards. The kicking team, number 92, it's a 15-yard penalty. First down.
So on that short kick, the Dinos, Jacob Clemond gets caught inside that restraining zone. Again, can't really fault him there on a short kick.
Well, it's tough, especially when that ball's hanging up in the wind. And then again, that's just that young freshman wanting to make some plays, just want to get downfield and make a tackle.
And it looks like Theo Dizar starting at quarterback here in the second half for Manitoba. He's going to go deep right away. Good coverage by the Dinos, and that is incomplete. The intended receiver, Macho Boku. Tony, a couple of key stats from the first half. I heard Wayne Harris on the in-house interview not happy with the number of penalties. With that no yards penalty, that's 9 penalties for the Dinos on the play. You talked about time of possession. Manitoba winning that almost 2-1 in the first half, 19-11.
Again, Manitoba doing what they need to win this game. They got to win ugly, they got to win with possession, and they got to win by just picking it down the field.
Steven Ugbaugh, wide right for Manitoba on second down and 10. Dizar with time, launches over the middle, has a man in traffic, complete, down by the goal line. Let's see where they mark this one. Looks like it's going to be at about the 1 yard line. They go vertical to Jesse Walker.
Again, that explosive speed of Jesse Walker. Jesse Walker was able to get inside position there on Adam Lorenz. Schmidt, the safety, doesn't get over in time. And a beautiful strike by Dizar. This could be the rebirth of Theo Dizar. Again, his best throws, Dave, are vertical. He's got a good strong arm, and he throws the vertical route beautifully.
4 of 6, that's going to get him over 100 yards passing on the day. Set up Manitoba, first and goal at the 1. Jamel Lyles up to the line, and Dizar is just going to keep it going to the line. We've got a flag coming in, which, of course, generally means the defense lined up offside. No signal yet. From the officials.
Again, looks like that Dino D line got some good push there, but as you stated, Dave, normally when short yardage, when the flag comes out early, it is the defensive line lining up offside.
Hey, you talked about the Dinos' lack of a running game, as it is offside Dinos. Jamel Lyles, again, not able to make much of an impact. 9 carries for 30 yards.
Defense, number 7. Ball replayed, first down at the 1 yard line.
Yeah, they're calling Cyril Iwanabe for lining up offside.
Cyril Iwanabe there on the edge, maybe not knowing that he had creeped up into that neutral zone.
That gives Manitoba an extra shot after the Dinos had stopped them on first down. Dizar under center, and he tries the right-hand side, and a flag comes in again. Touchdown, Manitoba.
And again, they're going to decline this, but again, it was Cyril Iwanabe trying to time the snap. Got into the neutral zone, got back, but once you cross the neutral zone, Dave, it's offside. So the Bisons will be declining this.
It's number 7. That penalty's declined.
Second straight offside penalty as the Dinos now into double digits on penalties in Manitoba. Even with the Dinos pending the extra point, we're tied up at 20 with 12:44 here to go in the third quarter.
Again, great answer for Manitoba for that field goal. Late in the first half by the Dinos, stuffing the Dinos. I believe we have Theo Dizar's mother there in the crowd waving. Oh, sorry, I apologize. Catillier's mom, I stand corrected. Obviously, she lives in Calgary. Cochrane, that is a beautiful little town just out to the west of Calgary. We'd like to say hi out to the Catillier family coming out to support their son.
The mighty Cochrane Cobras football.
That's right. Rob McNabb, former teammate of mine, great football coach out there who's won a multitude of Tier 3 provincial championships, done an incredible job with that football program out in Cochrane.
So not the start the Dinos were looking for in the second half, as they have a quick 2-and-out. Esquerdo and Leonard are going to wait for this kick.
I think the Dinos might have had a little much too much turkey, Dave, on that break, because they're playing very undisciplined, very sloppy on both sides of the football, and Manitoba capitalizing on those mistakes.
You do wonder, you're coming off the bye. The last time you played, you had that huge first place emotional showdown with rival UBC, and you're coming back with a little bit of a flu bug going through the room, which I hear, and you're facing a team that you handled without a whole lot of trouble last time out. Kickoff is going to be taken by Esquerdo at the 2-yard line. He goes straight up the hash marks, cutting to the wide side of the field. Up to the 20, has a bit of a seam. 25, try and turn the corner. He'll go out of bounds, close to the 30-yard line.
Again, nice little wedge there set up to the right there as Dean Leonard just tucks in behind that wedge. Initially, he starts, like he's heading up the field, breaks it to the right, gets a solid 30-yard return.
Yeah, check that. That is Dean Leonard on the return. A couple of good blocks just to set up that seam. So the Dinos first to 10, and the ball is just short of the 30-yard line. 12 and a half minutes to go. The Dinos now trail 21-20. Sinagra with Jeshua Antwi in the backfield. Antwi releases. Quick strike. That is going to be about an 8-yard gain.
Again, just two receivers to the short side of the field, which is the right in this situation, Dave. Just a nice little Hunter Carl, I believe, just heading down about 8 yards, curling up in front of the numbers, and a quick strike for Sinagra.
Hunter Carl, 2 catches, 24 yards, and a touchdown in the first half. Hand off to Antwi inside, not much doing there. I'm not sure if he got to the first down marker. I don't think so.
Again, great job by the inside tackles there of the Bisons. I believe it was Adamson and Watson getting penetration, tripping up Antwi before he could get any momentum. He still falls forward close enough to make Ryan Sheehan want to go for it, Dave.
Yeah, third down and a short yard. They have to get to about the 40-yard line. And the nose of the football is just past the 39. Joseph straight ahead, and we've got flags in here. So let's see if this time Manitoba got caught lining up offside.
Again, it's a shame if Manitoba's offside, because Manitoba just got some great penetration there. That O-line, again, playing with two true freshmen at tackle, didn't get any push at all, Dave.
And it is a Bisons penalty.
And that is Bisons offside. Again, and for Manitoba, that's their fourth penalty of the day.
Again, Davey, the Dinos dodging a bullet there.
5-yard penalty and a first down.
Totally no push that time. And maybe because the Bisons being offside allowed him to get that that inside position there, because the Dino offensive line didn't get any push.
Strange game for the Dinos. They've shown some big play explosiveness, but just haven't been able to get that consistency. And this time, Sinagra gets the ball batted back in his face.
Again, the Bisons sending heat up the middle, sending an inside linebacker blitz right up the middle that time. The defenders, they're getting their hands up and batting that ball down.
Tyler Fong coming on the blitz that time. Second down and 10. Ball's on the 44-yard line, just about 11 minutes to go. Daziuk lines up wide to the left-hand side. Sinagra sidesteps the rush. He's going to have to take off the run, and he's got room to midfield. 50, 45, 40, pushed out of bounds by the 39-yard line. They're going to call that down to the 37. So, again, just a great sense, but there's a flag back at the 35-yard line. I think this one's coming back. On the replay here, you see Sinagra. Nothing there. That left side open up, and he just took off. Either a hold or maybe a block in the back. We'll wait for the call here.
It looks like it's going to be a hold, Dave. It's a hold. And a roughing on the Dinos. Again, you can't hit a defensive player once the runner has passed the play there. And again, peel back blocks, Dave. They're there to protect the player. So the Dinos here, undisciplined, holding, and an unnecessary roughness.
Peel back block, tourist hit, whatever you want to call it, against the rules.
Exactly, Dave. Total undisciplined.
Okay, let's see that replay one more time, see if we can pick up where this all goes wrong.
You can see the hold here by Jeshron Antwi on number two there for the Bisons. Houston Rennie, the linebacker, he grabs cloth there, doesn't allow him to get the angle on Sinagra. That's the holding call.
The 4 yards gain, we had holding on the offense. We had unnecessary roughness, number 61 on the offense. back 25 yards, repeat second down.
So Curtis Cron gets tagged for the unnecessary roughness. Wow.
Again, just puts the Dinos in a crazy second
down. Forever.
Exactly, Dave. I don't know how many plays you got in your playbook for second in Vancouver here, bud, but the Bisons keeping their cool, forcing the Dinos to play undisciplined football, and the Dinos are playing right into the Bison's hands.
Yeah, actually, Dinos head north, so we'll call it second and Red Deer.
There you go. This.
Second down and 35 as they push the ball all the way back to the 19-yard line. Dinos, four receivers to the wide side on the left. Sinagra takes off immediately to the left-hand side, heading for the sideline. Pressure. He takes a shot out of bounds. That looked like a design run all the way as the linebacker, Brody Williams, came over and knocked him out.
It looked like they missed the exchange, Dave. I think they looked like they were going to stretch run play to the left that time. Not a good exchange between Adam Sinagra and Jeshron Antwi. And again, the Bisons do a great job pinning the Dinos deep while they have the wind. This is great for the Bisons. They're utilizing their time with the wind. You know, Nick DeFonte here has to kick into a heavy breeze again. Great job by that Bison defense.
Lyles on the near side, McCoy on the wide side. As DeFonte, he's probably punted more today than he has in any game so far this season. And just a bad shank as this one is going to go out of bounds. Doesn't even get to the Bison 40-yard line.
Again, that Bison bench is jacked. They're alive, Dave. They're flying off the field, onto the field. I mean, they're just playing with a lot of passion here tonight. And you can just see that Dino football team is very flat. You look at that Dino defense, heads down. You know, there's not a skip in the step. And that Bison offense, they're running onto the field, Dave. They're excited. You know, it's almost like they can smell blood. They want to score again.
That was a net of what, 15, 16 yards on that punt? So it's going to be first and 10 for Manitoba, practically in the red zone now. Ball's just inside the Dinos 37. 10:13 to go as the clock starts to move. Dezarp, handoff to Lyles, tries the right-hand side of the line, and he's going to move ahead to about the 32-yard line. That'll be a gain of 7.
Again, Lyles there doing that little stutter step left, coming back to the right. He's very patient here. He kind of waits for his line to give him a crease there. He sees a bit of a crease, shoots through it. He's very powerful, and he gets a solid 4-yard gain, Dave.
Yeah, they give him less than I thought, so it's going to be second down. In field goal range, but the Bison's going to want more. They already have one touchdown so far this half and now have the lead at 21-20. Dezar with the empty backfield. Fires over the middle, has a man wide open down at the goal line, incomplete. Jesse Walker just couldn't catch up with that ball.
Again, Jesse Walker gets inside position on that young defender, the true freshman Dean Leonard that time, but the pressure gets to Dezar, doesn't allow him to step into the throw, and the Dinos defense here dodges a bullet, Dave.
So yeah, if you could get away with just giving up a field goal on this, 4-point game instead of an 8-point game.
Well, considering, Dave, you got backed up about 30 yards and you don't execute a great punt into the wind, this would be good for the Dinos to get off the field with them just getting a field goal.
And Brad Mikuloff, 2 of 3, as he drives this one straight ahead and through. So with 9 minutes to go in the third quarter, the Bisons take a 24-20 lead. The Dinos not going to take any chances on a return. Looks like they're just going to take the ball at the 35.
And again, good call, because they haven't been getting it past the 25. So again, taking the ball on the 35 and hoping to sustain a bit of drive. I mean, that Dino defense has got to be sucking wind right now. They've been on the field pretty well for the first 6 minutes of this second half. That Dino offense needs to string some first downs to give that defense a bit of a breather.
So after a strong first half, Adam Sinagra not able to get much of anything going. Dino start with a two-back set. Bobby Stewart is deep, stays in the block. Sinagra out of the backfield. That is complete to Klukas. He's going to be over at the 37-yard line. He'll have a gain of maybe a couple of yards.
Again, Adam Sinagra looking deep. There's a
Brendan Thera on the catch.
Adam Sinagra looking deep, Dave. Some vertical routes there, three receivers to the right. The two inside receivers going deep, nobody open. Sinagra comes off to his out route there, which was Thera Plamondon, but just for a short gain of about 3 yards.
Sandani lines up in the slot on the left-hand side.
Whoa.
Looking back to the far sideline, and that one's incomplete over by the Dino bench. So it's going to be another quick two and out for the Dinos, and DeFonte is going to have to punt into that wind, which has been giving him nightmares this quarter.
And again, Dave, it's hard thrown into that wind. Like, looks like Sinagra's having a real tough time trying to get a spiral into that wind. You can see the flags. It's blowing hard. It's swirling. And he just can't get a good snap on that football. And this is where a running game comes in huge, Dave. If you got a running game, you don't have to rely on throwing a pass, on second and medium. And this is really killing the Dinos into the wind.
That running game has not been there. You can just see the goalposts are rattling with this wind. So DeFonte ready to let it go with just one man back. 8 minutes on the clock now, and the Bisons enjoying that four-point lead. DeFonte punts it to the near side, gets away a decent punt, holds up at the 50-yard line, taken by one of the short backs, and this one could go. Number 21, the up-back, Shea Weeks taking it. There's a flag down to the 50. This is going to be a no-yards play, again, on a short punt.
Again, their left starting defensive back, Weeks, heads-up play, catches that on the fly. I mean, he's back there to block, and so the Dino defender doesn't expect him to catch a football, but that thing hangs up there. He's just beautiful heads-up play, catches it, catches the Dino player with no yards also, and it looks like the Bisons are going to start an incredible field position here. Bison's just doing a wonderful job of utilizing the wind here, Dave, in the third quarter.
7:44 to go before the Dinos get the win back. 7:44 to go for the big arm of Theo Dizar to try to put some more points on the board.
We had no yards. 15-yard yards, the kicking team. That penalty's declined. First down, White.
So a decline on the no yards because the return yardage was greater.
Again, Dave, just
about a 20-yard return, I do believe.
Again, just great just option for the Bisons to have.
Running back. Michael Lucas, number 19.
So that defense, again, on short rest, back on the field. At least there's a timeout down on the field now.
Frosted Flakes,
Honey Nut Cherry.
Stylish.
Some defensive stats for the Dinos in the first half. Adam Lorenz
Golf.
Is the leading tackler with four and an assist. Micah Tights with three tackles. Matthew Carson credited with one sack.
Matthew Carson from Kelowna. Going into his fifth year, had a great stint with the Toronto Argonauts during training camp. Good young athlete, and having himself a solid year this year, Dave.
And the Dinos needing another defensive stand here. Boston Rowe with an interception in the first half.
And you can see they're tired, Dave. You can see the D-line, buddy. Yep. They got their
hands on the hips.
And there's just some fire in that Manitoba offense. I mean, Theo Dizar getting the opportunity to possibly win his job back and making some plays, Dave. Making plays even before the half. Caught me off guard. Didn't realize they had made the switch. And he had thrown two beautiful passes to take him down the field for the last score before the half. So great, great performance so far by Theo Dizar.
Theo Dizar reborn in that 76-17 blowout. 29 points off turnovers for the Dinos. And 8 sacks to the Manitoba quarterbacks. That was the first time we saw Nez Cattelier. But now with Cattelier struggling in front of his hometown crowd, the veteran Theo Dizar getting a second chance at trying to make the most of it. Play whistled in. Dizar with the empty backfield as Lyle stays in to block. Dizar is going to scramble, puts his head down, jumps over a Dino defender, gets down to the 29-yard line, and you just hear that big roar coming
again,
up from the bench.
That's just inspired, fearless play by their quarterback. I mean, that whole sideline there of Manitoba erupts because Theo Dizar is just laying it on the line. I mean, he's a big body. He's hurling linebackers. He's getting nailed and falling forward. I mean, this is inspired football by this Bison offense.
They give him 6 yards, second and four, just inside the 30-yard line, empty backfield again. Dizar looking towards the end zone and the corner, and that is incomplete. Good coverage by Dean Leonard on Shea Ross that time.
Again, the young freshman corner from Notre Dame High School here in Calgary, stride for stride with the veteran Ross. And I mean, Ross is no slouch himself, Dave. Very explosive veteran receiver, great play by the young Dean Leonard.
Brad Mikuloff sets the tee down on the 36-yard line.
And that looks like a square though. Deep for the Dinos, just in case.
If he makes this, Dave, the Dinos should be very thankful that it's only a one score differential with the amount of time that this Manitoba offense has had the football.
And Mikuloff, 3 of 4 as he puts it through from 36 yards. And that gives the Bisons a 7-point lead with 6:40 to go. But again, they do have the lead. They're playing well, but a couple of missed opportunities here drives ending in field goals instead of touchdowns. And that's going to be a big breath of relief to the Dinos.
And again, Dave, they're playing inspired football. They're playing great football. They're doing everything. But as you stated, when you have opportunities in the red zone and you don't get majors, you get field goals instead of majors, that can come back to bite you.
Sandani splits off wide left. Klukas is wide right. Robbie Stewart in the backfield. He will play action. Sinagra rolling right. Nowhere to go, and he is just going to lob this one up. Looked like Jeshrin Antwi out there. That was incomplete.
Again, some indecision there by Sinagra. He pulls it, looking to throw downfield. Nobody's open. Great coverage that time by the Manitoba defense. I think Sinagra would have been better off to run. Again, he tries to float it into Jeshrin, who probably isn't one of your most sure-handed receivers there. Next time, I think Adam should just decide to tuck it.
There were positive yards there for Adam Sinagra.
Yeah, there was. There was.
6:15 to go. Sinagra with time over the middle, sails that one. And that was over Hunter Carl and over everybody. And again, another two and out.
Well, exactly, Dave. And again, those inside curl routes have been open there for the Dinos. But for some reason, they've been sailing on Adam Sinagra now. Now you got to start to wonder, Dave, do you maybe give Josiah Joseph a chance and spark this offense?
I think you might, because certainly it was about this time in the last game when Sinagra was struggling in the third quarter that we saw Josiah Joseph come on. But Nico DeFonte, he has to help out his team here. He's had a couple of terrible punts back-to-back. He needs to get underneath one here. Boots this one to the sideline. It's another short kick. That one bounces to Lyles. Lyles at the 50-yard line. The Dinos, again, very aware of the problems DeFonte is having. No yards that time around, but another short field for Manitoba. They'll start on the Dino 48 with 5:42 to go in the third.
And again, you can see that Taylor Altilio's made the special teams coach has made some adjustments where he brought 3-4 wings out wide to the left because of that short kick so that they could kind of funnel in the returner there. And the referees made a good call that time. The ball hit, bounced back, saw the Dinos were trying to get back and didn't throw the no yards flag.
Mark the ball at the 46, first and 10. Deezer, play action, rolls, looks left under pressure, fires, and that one is almost intercepted. It was intended for Jesse Walker, and the Dino defender getting over there. That was Matthew Lecision, almost got his hands.
Again, I think it's the two-year vet, Matthew Lecision from Bishop Grandin, that time was able to come. He was helping over top. I believe Cyril Wannabe had the coverage underneath, and Lucician was able to come over top and almost got himself a pick there. Sorry, Schmidt had the coverage underneath, Lucician over top. Lucician does a great job, breaks on that ball beautifully, and just slips through his fingers.
Dino defense looking to hold one more time here. Clock ticking awards, 5 minutes. Dizar with the empty backfield and time over the middle, and that is incomplete. He just flat out missed Jesse Walker.
Well, at that time, there was some great coverage there by Boston Roll. They were trying to send Jesse Walker. He was the right inside receiver to the right side of the field. Dave coming across the middle there. Boston Roll, the middle linebacker, right on his hip. They also had pressure from Adam Lorenz with a halfback blitz. Dizar felt the pressure, threw it into the ground, and actually the Dinos here could win a little bit of field position advantage here. But looks like
a little bit of confusion for Manitoba. They're going to try a 54-yarder.
And why not, Dave? I mean, they got that big win behind you. Why not?
Jaden McCoy puts his knee down on the 54. And we've got a timeout on the field. Looks like the Dinos calling timeout to talk this over.
Again, maybe they want to make sure they just got the right personnel out there, Dave. I mean, this is what makes the Canadian game, Dave, I think fantastic, is the big 100-yard field goal returns for touchdowns. You know, a la Henry the Gizmo Williams and you know, many, many other great returners. But Jacob Esquardo is very athletic, very, very quick. So if the Bisons do not get a good kick, and he can catch this clean, look at the real estate between him. And usually when you're kicking field goals, Dave, I know a lot of teams change it up now and they put more defensive guys on the field goal team. But a lot of times you have some offensive linemen and maybe some offensive personnel out there that aren't the best cover guys.
And this wind is hard to read. If you look at the flags on the goalpost, it looks like it's blowing straight north to south. But then you look at the flags on the side, it looks like it's cutting off left to right.
It looks like we have just like a little mini cyclone happening here inside McMahon Stadium, Dave.
So Mikuloff from 54 yards. And you saw the Dino swap that personnel group to get a speed group out there. It's a line drive, and it is going to miss wide to the left. And Esquerdo is going to take it out of the end zone. 10, 15 to the 20, cuts it back at the 25-yard line. So the Dinos keep this a one-score game and get the football back on the 25, looking to get something going.
And again, it looks like when they had that timeout, Dave, they actually were setting up a return off of that. If you could see that, instead of going for the block, Dave, they jammed the Manitoba Bisons, and then about four or five Dinos peeled back to the right and set a nice picket fence there for Esquardo.
So the Dinos have been unable to move the ball here in the second half. Sanagua remains in. Handoff to Jeshua Antwi. That was not a well-executed play. They brought the slot back. Hunter Carl came across to fake that jet sweep, and he actually collided with Sanagua right on the snap.
Again, Dave, just some bad timing there. I mean, you want that slot back coming across to kind of freeze the linebackers, right? And then come back with the dive. But Jeshron Antwi just running a little bit tentative too there, buddy. Trying to dance, you gotta hit that line.
Loss of about half a yard, second down, 10 and change. Sanagra over the middle, this one is complete. That looks like Hunter Carl spins to the 45 for a first down. Hunter Carl, you gotta go back to your defendable guy when you need to move the chains.
And there's no question, and those deep hooks, Dave, have been there all game. Those intermediate hooks, it's just the ball has been sailing on Sanagra. That time, steps into the throw, Dave, gets it lower and right on the numbers of Hunter Carl.
And Sanagra spinning off safety Tyler Fong, able to gain a couple of extra yards. Jeshua Antwi into the right side of the line, pushes ahead for, I think that's about three.
Okay, and you know what I like about that, Dave, is he was aggressive on that run. The last run, he was dancing, he didn't get anything. There wasn't much there. The Manitoba D-line did a good job, but he got nice and low. He's a big, strong running back, and boom, he powered for 3 yards.
Second and six opens a lot more of the playbook. Down to 3:15 here. Receivers in motion to the left. Sanagra looks back to the right for Klukas at the sideline. Complete. Steps out of bounds at the 51-yard line of Manitoba first down.
And you made a great point, Dave. Okay, even 3 yards, 4 yards. Now you only need, like you said, a 7-yard out into this wind. Those are makeable throws, and that's what he did there. He threw a 7-yard out into that wind, moving the chains and winning the real estate.
And Marcel Aruda Welch was playing well off Michael Klukas, and Klukas, all he had to do was come 5 yards off the line, make that cut to the outside, an easy first down. Sanagra with the handoff to Antwi, trying the left-hand side, cuts back a little bit of room. He is down inside the 40-yard line to the 37. First down, Dinos on a 13-yard gain.
Again, that's that stretch play to the short side of the field here to the left, where the offensive line all step to the left. They run a rail here, Dave. They got to stick shoulder to shoulder. You see that beautiful rail there, which allows Jeshron to hide behind that rail, find the seam, and then once he sees it, he shoots through there, sticks that foot, shoots through there, and accelerates for a big gain, Dave.
Went off the left shoulder of center Darius Scirocco into that gap. Sanagra back to pass. Looking to the near sideline, in and out of the hands of Michael Klukas.
Again, big cushion that time by Aruda Welch. Maybe Adam Sanagra could have maybe thrown that just a touch sooner. Again, hard into that win. But Welch does a nice job of sticking his foot, breaking underneath that, and almost getting an interception.
2:20 to go. Dinos trying to work against this win. This is the first time in this second half that they have had any kind of success moving the ball. The drive started back at their own 25-yard line. Antwi stays in the block, now releases Sanagra all kinds of time, over to the far sideline, and that one almost intercepted, intended for Hunter Carl, and that is incomplete.
And again, very, very gutsy throw by Sinagra. Obviously, if you're a Manitoba defender, you're going to give that wide side curl route open because, one, in the Canadian Football League, you're throwing 60 yards across the field. Two, you're thrown into the wind. So I'm surprised Adam Sinagra attempted to even throw that pass.
Well, we've seen Nico DeFonte kick field goals from this distance, but no way you're going to try it with this wind. And the advantage to DeFonte here, even though he hasn't been getting great leg here, all you have to do is get that ball inside the 20 and roll it out of bounds.
You might almost want to try a fake here, Dave. What do you got to lose? I mean,
now with the ball down at the 37 and inside 2 minutes to go. High snap, DeFonte pulls it in. Line drive kick. This one is going to bounce at the 5 and rolls out
what
of bounds. I think he killed
kick.
It at the 1 yard
line. He did.
Line.
He did, David. And you know what? Brilliant kick by DeFonte. He just had a low trajectory on that kick. Almost cut underneath the current of the wind there, Dave. Bounced on about the 5 and just basically went out of bounds on the 2. Can't ask for a better kick than that.
Coffin corner kick by Nico DeFonte, who had struggled mightily. Let's see the replay on this. He was lucky to get that snap down. And just the line drive here, and that one just bounced and turned left. Looked like it was going to roll into the end zone.
And you can see the Bison coaches losing their minds. They told their returners, get out of the end zone, and they didn't. They stayed a little deep, and they allowed it to hit the ground and get out of bounds.
Dizar in the gun in his end zone. First and 10, handoff to Lyle straight ahead. He's going to take it up to close to the 10-yard line. Just bowled that pile. Initial contact was about 2 yards, and the rest of that was all number 22.
Well, again, great job by the center, Daly, and the two guards, Clarkson and McMorris there of Manitoba, getting great push up the middle there. And Lyles, for a compact back, Dave, quick, he's extremely tough. And what he did is he gave his quarterback a little more breathing room out of the end zone.
Under a minute to go. Big, big series for the Dinos here. Ideally, you'd like Manitoba to be pinned deep and then have to punt from the other side. That is going to be a short completion. 2 Lyles out of the backfield. It'll be good for a first down.
Again,
on the 15-yard line.
Great hands by the running back there, showing receiver-type hands. He gets one-on-one coverage there out into the flat there. Adam Lorenz trying to get out there. The ball's a little bit thrown behind him, but he just kind of sinks the hips, Dave. Turns around, soft hands, makes a great catch. Keeps his drive going for his offense.
And as I say, though, that first down, if the Dinos could dig in here and stop him, that could actually help him because Manitoba, if they can flip the field for the fourth quarter, would have to punt deep. There's a completion out to the 25, comes to another first down. That was Tristan Dice.
Again, just a little bit of a rub route there, Dave, where the inside receiver runs it out, the outside receiver runs a slant, hoping to get the Dino defenders to kind of get caught up in traffic that time. Beautifully timed ball there by Dizar. Throws it right off the break, hits the receiver in stride, another first down. Theo Dizar looking very sharp in this game, Dave.
And Dice checking out of the game after making the catch. Kyle Patchell comes in. Patchell will split wide right. 10 seconds on the clock. This should be the last play of the third quarter. Dizar with the empty backfield one more time. Has to step up. Dizar's going to run. He's heading for the sideline, looking for the first down marker, and he gets there at the 35-yard line with no time on the clock. Into the third quarter. 15 minutes of football to go here at McMahon Stadium. The upset-minded Manitoba Bisons with a 27-20 lead. You're watching Canada West TV and Dinos Football.
Time for the Coffee Cup Shuffle game. And there's our man Joe with the contestants.
Absolutely, and these guys are excited because they got a fan club too. We got Joey and Rashang here. They are ready to rock and roll with the Coffee Cup Challenge, right? You're good to go?
Oh yeah, we're good to go.
All right, let's go up to Dino Vision and let us play the Coffee Cup Shuffle. We got Dino's logo under number 3 to start. 2's in the middle, 1's on the left. We're gonna spin around, to and fro, away we go. And it starts slow, then it gets kind of confusing, and then it's gonna be up to the fans to help out Joey and Rashang. Playing from Churchill, part of the junior team over there. Hopefully they're having a pretty good season so far. Can they get their season even better? Here's the question though. Is it under number 1? Is it under number 2? Is it under number 3? These guys figured it was 1 from the get-go. Is that what you're saying? Is that your final answer? You're locking in?
Yeah, we're going with 1.
All right, let's go back up to Dino Vision. Is it under number 1? That is the question. Are they going to get that prize? It's under number two. What the heck? Were you, gonna, you went with your team, right? You guys thought that the team was right all along.
I have to blame Adrian Pham on that one.
They're blaming teammates now. We got great prizes for the two of you guys anyways. Thanks for coming down and playing. Best of luck the rest of the season. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Joey Rasheng. And, of course, make some noise for the boys, your University of Calgary Dinos!
Congratulations, Frankie Race. You're the lucky winner of our Beats Solo 3 wireless headphones. Please make your way to the bottom of Section X, and you can claim that great prize.
Here at McMahon Stadium, the Manitoba Bisons smelling the upset here, looking to knock the Dinos off their unbeaten perch. 27-20, the visitors lead. What a turnaround this is from the first game between these two clubs, a laugher, which the Dinos took 76-17. And the story is that man right there, Theo Dizark. He was the quarterback who lost his job in that Dino blowout, came off the bench for Des Catelier before the half, and has ignited this Manitoba offense. And just think about this drive after that great coffin quarter punt by Nico DeFonte at the two. Now first attempt at the 36 at Manitoba, jumping offside. That's going to push him back 5 yards.
Again, Manitoba, not a lot of penalties. That's only their fifth penalty of the game, Dave, whereas the Dinos, on the other hand, have 14 penalties for 110 yards, which is also the story of this game. Lack of discipline, making a lot of mistakes. And again, possession, Dave, 25 minutes to 19 minutes again. So Dinos playing sloppy, Dave. The offense not being able to move the football, and that defense getting tired.
Dave Rona, Tony Spalatini bringing you the action on a windy October day for McMahon Stadium. That wind now blowing in the face of Theo Dizar and the Manitoba offense. Gave the Dinos all kinds of grief in the third quarter. They only managed about 60 yards of offense. Let's see what Dizar with that big arm is able to do. Handoff inside. That one goes absolutely nowhere as Jamel Lyles gets sniffed out and stuffed.
Again, just an incredible job that time. I believe it was Matt Carson who was able to knife in there, just blow up the right guard of Manitoba and stuff Lyles right in the hole. And I mean, they bring in, I believe Manitoba brings in their big H-back, who is number 55, Reed Morris, who's another old lineman, to kind of give him that extra blocking, but that didn't even help on that play, Dave. Great job there by Matt Carson, just getting penetration and blowing that up.
Lost a yard. Jamel Lyles held to about 40 yards on the ground as that threat's been contained so far. Empty backfield for Dizar on second and 16. Dizar puts it up, has the man complete, short of the first down at the 41-yard line as Jesse Walker comes down with the ball. Six catch, he's over 100 yards receiving for the day.
Again, Jack McEwen getting some pressure up the middle there, Dave, but still, Dave, just admire the composure of Theo Dizar, feeling the heat, stepping in there. And that's when you got a tall, big quarterback. He's able to see over that pressure, Dave, and almost got a first down there. Great play by Theo Dizar.
And Matt Riley, I think this wind has dropped off a little bit. Riley so far in the punting game is averaging 35 and a half yards on two punts. Let's see what he's able to do with a square toe back at the 20-yard line for the Dinos. Again, Nico DeFonte struggled. Had two bad punts early before that coffin corner. And Riley, an end-over-end punt. It's going to bounce at the 30 into the hands of Esquerdo at the 25. He just goes north and south to the 30-yard line.
Again, just great cover there by the Manitoba cover team. Not much for Esquerdo to get. He gets it off the one hopper, goes north-south, which is good. The Dinos, with the wind at their backs now, are starting on their own 31-yard line, Dave.
So let's see what happens here. Remember, Manitoba had all the momentum in that third quarter, but they had a couple of drives that ended in field goals instead of touchdowns with the win. The Dinos got a little bit of momentum at the end of the third quarter, a drive that ended with that coffin corner punt. Let's see if they're able to build on it. Joshua Antwi and Robbie Stewart both in the backfield. Antwi splits off to the left. Sinagra hand off to Stewart. He cuts back inside. He'll get to about the 35-yard line, have 3 yards.
Again, just trying to try that little stretch lead play to the left where they have Joshua Antwi leading him, trying to seal the corner there that time. Looked like there was a seam, but there was a nice play there by the interior left defensive tackle of Manitoba, who was able to get across. I believe it was Watson, able to get across, get off the block, and trip up Robbie Stewart for a short gain.
And Marcel Arruda-Welch, again, lining up on Michael Klukas. Let's see where they go on this one. Sinagra drops it out of the backfield to Antwi. Antwi at the 40, makes a man miss, gets to the 45, 47-yard line. First down, Dinos. Little bit of a hesitation move by Antwi, but then he was able to take off for the first down. We've got a Dino down by the far sideline.
Again, Jeshron, when you get that check down running back in open space, that's smart by Sinagra, just dumps the ball out to Antwi. You get him one-on-one, he's got to make people miss one-on-one. He does that. But now Jeshron's got to have better ball control, Dave. Late again on that play, the ball comes loose, right? And he's got to work on that ball possession there, Jeshron.
And that was a Darius Scirocco. Dino slow to get up on the play. He rumbled back to the huddle, didn't want help from the trainer, so he had to come up. Handoff inside. Stewart bounces to the outside. Midfield, he's got room. 50 to the 40 to the 30. Manitoba defender cuts him off at the 20, tries to tiptoe on the line. Out of bounds at the 15, and the Manitoba defender, R.J. Shelley, is down. I think he might have got just an accidental kick on the way by.
But just a beautifully block play that time, Dave. Again, it's that stretch right. They call it the rail. Everybody shoulder to shoulder, and they get a beautiful seal. Robbie Stewart hides in behind those linemen and then just breaks it to the outside and uses solid speed to get a huge run game that time. Spark that this Dino offense needed.
And R.J. Shelley able to knock him out of bounds, but as I say, I think he might have got just an accidental kick on the way by, as he is still down on the field.
It looks like Robbie Stewart might have accidentally stepped on his hand, Dave, or maybe.
Let's look at that low angle replay one more time, as Shelley is up and making his way to the Manitoba bench.
While we're waiting, Dave, oh sorry, here we go. Again, you see that great seal there. Everybody caves that whole right side of the D-line in there. Jeshron Antwi, the extra running back, getting the seal, and it allows Robbie Stewart to get outside.
Yeah, there's the step right there. So it's first down for the Dinos at the 10-yard line. Sinagra didn't like what he saw and called timeout. And so the Dinos have used both of their timeouts here in the second half. But again, good call by Sinagra. So important to get a touchdown off this drive.
Dave, you alluded to it. You said, Tone, even though Manitoba's moving the football, they're getting points, but they're not getting majors, right, Dave? So as much as they kept that Dino defense on the field, they owned the possession when they had the win, they only really came out of it with 6 points. And now the Dinos, with one score, have tied it up. Again, you got to get majors when you're in the red zone.
Sinagra, 16 of 31. He has 2 touchdowns and an interception, 226 yards through the air. Right now, all he's thinking is 10 yards and a foot. That's what he needs for the touchdown. Signals for motion. There's the handoff inside to Stewart. Stewart surges ahead to about the 7-yard line.
And again, Brock Gawanluk, the left inside tackle the left end of the Manitoba Bisons, was able to come off the block of the young right tackle, I believe it was Bandy, and make that play and limit the gain of, Tyler Packer going against that veteran Manitoba lineman who's done admirably tonight, but that time Gawanluk was able to come off the block, make the play, and limit it to a short gain.
Second and 7 from the 7. Sinagra with the empty backfield has it batted back into his face, and it's intercepted by Manitoba. That ball pinballing around into the hands of the defensive lineman, Cole Adamson.
Again, just a brilliant play by Cole Adamson there. Wasn't, you're taught as a defensive lineman, if you can't come off the block clean, get pressure, and then just put up your hands once you think the quarterback is going to throw the football. He does that, bats it up into the air, and catches it himself.
Here's the replay.
Again, bats it up into the air, and then catches it himself. Just a super job there by Adamson. and snuffs the first really solid drive the Dinos have had since early in the second quarter.
10.5 minutes to go as Manitoba takes over at the 21-yard line with a 7-point lead. Dizar with the handoff. Lyles trying to turn the corner. He'll get to the 25 before he's run out of bounds. Whoa, vaulting over those advertising signs.
Again, just super athletic that time. That time, incredible, that counterplay, but a nice job of the right tackle for Manitoba. Williams gets a good seal that time on the Dino defensive end, which allows Lyles to get outside, turns the corner, and gets a solid 7-yard gain.
That's a hard-working 7 yards as you'll ever see.
Oh, no question.
Kyle Patchell splitting out wide to the left. Dizar signals the motion with the right foot. Looks to the right-hand side, and that one goes off the back of the Dino defender, incomplete.
Again, great play that time. I believe that was Cyril Wannabe, who's was covering Walker on that play. He was the inside receiver to the right. The short side linebacker, Wannabe, short side to the left there, was able to get across at the last minute, get his hand, knock that ball down. Great defensive play there. Actually, I stand corrected. It was a middle linebacker, Boston Rowe, came from his middle position, gets across there, knocks the ball down. And again, field position here is crucial. We'll see how Riley kicks into the wind.
And the goalposts are starting to rattle as the wind picks up once again. Leonard and Esquerdo waiting back on either side of their 40-yard line for this one. Inside 9:50 to go. Play clock down to 5 as the snap comes back. Pressure by the Dinos. Don't run into the kicker this time. Dean Leonard steps up, takes it at midfield, and he gets a shot right away. I don't know where the no yards call was on that, because it seemed like there was an awful lot of traffic around Dean Leonard when he caught the ball.
Again, I think a little inconsistency here, Dave, with the no yard calls. I think there was no attempt there to really slow down, and that ball kind of hung up in the air there. Again, questionable non-call there, but great job by that young returner to hang on to the football after that big hit.
Dinos will take over first and 10, 52.5-yard line of Manitoba. 9.5 minutes to go. They trail by 7 after turning the ball over inside the 10. Sinagra back to pass. Flag comes in, complete over by the far sideline. Be a gain of about 7 or 8 if it holds up.
And just a little quick out route there to Klukas. He gets a big cushion by the corner. Because of his speed, he sees that, pretends he's going to go deep, breaks it off at 8 yards. Sinagra puts it on a rope, and it's a solid 8-yard game, unless that's a call against the Dinos.
I think Manitoba signaling it's against them.
We have offside. Defense, number 99. It's a 5-yard penalty. Feet first down.
Yeah, so you take that penalty because the gain was about 7 yards, so you take
exactly
the extra down on that.
There's no question, Dave.
Marcel Arruda-Welch is giving a very healthy cushion to Michael Klukas, as Klukas has just blown past him a few times in this game. They're looking that way again, and underneath, this one is complete. Hunter Carl cuts back in. He's got room to run, puts his head down, gets inside the 35-yard line. First down, Dinos.
Again, Hunter Carl is extremely talented, not only running routes, but running with the football after he catches it that time. Does a great job of juking and making the first guy miss, and then boom, making the second guy miss, heads north-south. What I like about him, Dave, is that after he makes the guys miss, he goes north-south, lowers the shoulder, and powers in. For I believe he's about 180 pounds, he's extremely tough. Tough receiver.
Linebacker is the injured member of the Manitoba Bisons as the trainers come out onto the field.
That would be a huge blow for the Bisons, Dave, as Gregoire is one of their stalwarts there in that defense. He's a leader in the middle of that field, and he's had himself a great game today so far. Now, Dave, we talked about Manitoba not taking advantage of their opportunities in the red zone. Well, the Dinos now can't fall into the same trap, right? Last time they come down virtually to the 5-yard line and turn the ball over, not even get a field goal, right?
Yep.
They are now down to, I believe, the 28-yard line. They got to come away with points here.
Dinos have had a couple of crazy interception turnovers deep in the red zone. Now, first of all, we're going to see a replay, see what happened to Donovan Gregoire here. Hunter Carl cuts back inside, and he just goes helmet to helmet with Hunter Carl.
I think even more shoulder to helmet, Dave. I think Gregoire had his chin down, right? And you're being taught now to have your chin up. I don't think Hunter Carl quite hit him as much with the crown. I just think that Gregoire hit Hunter Carl with his chin down and jammed his neck, right? And
so just that's unfortunate tough. Positioning.
It's just
by both
very
players.
Unfortunate. He was kind of caught back on his heels, Dave. He kind of ducked his head and hit Hunter Carl's shoulder with his chin down and probably jammed his neck. I hope it's nothing serious. It looks like
he's sitting up,
and that's a great positive sign. It looks like he's got movement.
Second replay from the low level. As you see, here's Hunter Carl. He's just getting ready for that contact. And yeah, you see both players duck it into the hit.
And again, Gregoire was catching. A lot of times, Dave, when you're catching, you're getting hurt.
You're absorbing that full shock.
Well, exactly. I think Gregoire normally is delivering the blow. That time, you know, Hunter Carl's so shifty, he caught him on his heels and he just lowered the shoulder. It's good to see the solid middle linebacker walking off.
Donovan Gregoire on his feet. It'll thin things out a little bit for that Manitoba defense as the backup, Kyle Gordon, is going to have to come in. I was just saying, a couple of crazy interceptions for the Dinos in the red zone. Of course, you had that one there. Ball batted up in the air, pinballs around before it's caught. Now, 2 weeks ago in the Saskatchewan game, there was an intended pass for, I think it was Michael Klukas. Klukas got a hand on it, tipped on it. It went off the face mask of a Saskatchewan defender, and there was another Saskatchewan defender lying on the ground, and it landed right in his chest.
Well, and I mean, Adam Sinagra is super athletic, but not being 6 foot plus, that's the disadvantage, I guess, you know, Dave?
Play action, looking for Carl down by the 5 yard line. He stretches out. They're gonna mark him down at the 1 yard line.
Again, just a beautiful touch pass by Adam Sinagra. Little fake dive, boot to the left there. They fake the run play, boot to the left. Hunter Carl, explosive, great route runner, gets a couple steps on the defender. Sinagra just lays it in beautifully. And looks like the short yardage team's coming out, Dave, because it's on the 1 yard line.
Josiah Joseph checks in. Hunter Carl looking for his second touchdown of the day, stretched out, came up just short. But again, the Dinos, when the chips are down, going to their main weapons, and those main weapons delivering. Joseph with the snap. He rolls to the left, and he's going to walk into the end zone.
What an incredible called play there of deception, Dave. The quarterback boot. Everybody motions to the right, fake the handoff to the right. They pull the right guard as Josiah's escort, but they really didn't hit anything but air. Great call by Ryan Sheehan there, and the Dinos get a much-needed major score here, Dave, with the win.
And they're not messing around. With 8.5 minutes still on the clock and the wind at their back, they're just sending Nico DeFonte on for the one-point convert just to tie this game. Let's see the replay on that. Joseph rolls out and again just takes his time walking into the end zone. That lead blocker there didn't have a whole lot of anything to do. Nico DeFonte perfect on the extra point. We are tied at 27 with 8.5 minutes to go.
Now, Dave, if you're Manitoba, if I'm Brian Dolby, you got to keep your team up right now because they've played an awesome football game. You know, for a team that was expected to do nothing here today, especially after that blowout at home, they've been super competitive, so they can't get down. If I'm Brian Dobie, I'm telling them, guys, we're still in this. Reload, don't worry about it. They did nothing in the third quarter. We picked it off, they just got a major now. Look, we can move the ball on these guys. So Manitoba, they want to stay in this game, Dave. They got to stay up.
Yeah, you are tied with the number two team in the nation, the mighty, mighty unbeaten Dinos in their house with 8.5 minutes to go. You got a chance to make a statement here. That's a pretty easy inspirational speech for Brian Dobie to make. And his team has had great energy. Let's see if they're able to maintain it.
Now, if you're the Dinos on the other hand, Dave, if I'm Wayne Harris, I'm saying, hey, we're gonna pin him deep, defense, get him 1-2 and out. We got some momentum now. Let's go down there and score another one.
And Nico DeFonte getting ready to kick this one off as the wind kicks up again. We're looking at that south goalpost rattling around. Jesse Walker and Shea Ross back deep to receive this.
It's funny,
Ross
Dave,
on the near side, Walker wide.
What's funny, Dave, it's like the flags are almost going straight up, man.
Yeah.
It's almost like a tornado. I think they're going to need someone to pin the football here. Like, really, the flags here, Dave, to our right, it's like they're going straight up in the air.
Yeah, and they are lining up.
That's Jacob Yakuchek playing the role of the holder here. And Defonte, with that leg in the wind, has a chance to give the Dinos a lead here. Line drive, that one is gonna roll into the end zone. And hustling back to get it is Jesse Walker, and he is just gonna take a knee. So the Dinos do take that 1-point lead.
Good call, Dave Wright, get the convert. You got the wind at your back. I mean, you know, I honestly think if I was Walker, I would actually maybe would have attempted to run that out, get it on the 20. I wouldn't be giving them any points right now, especially going into the wind.
I don't know if you heard, that was kind of a weird sounding kick, Tony. You could almost hear that.
I don't think he hit it clean, Dave, because it didn't have that nice spin on it. It almost had a sideways
spin. It sounded
almost
more like a volleyball getting hit. These are leading the offense out one more time. Actually, no, they're back to Catelier. Catelier under pressure. He is going to get tackled. Yeah, for a gain of about 1 yard. So again, another quarterback switch. I'm not sure about this one.
I'm just wondering, you know, is Dizar banged up or what's Brian Dobie's philosophy here? Are they basically mailing in the season and they just want to take a look at the young quarterback? Because Theo Dizar had the hot hand.
Yeah, Dizar just on the sideline. He looks okay. I think that was Jack McEwen on the tackle for the Dinos. So second down, they're going to give him a gain of 2 yards. So does Catelia back in front of, no doubt, some of his old St. Francis teammates. Has time now, rolling right. Lofts the ball up into the air. This one is hanging up. And again, the wind blew that one up. That was a bad decision by the young quarterback. He was throwing off his back foot into the wind. That ball just hung up, but luckily the wind took it out of bounds before Michael Schmidt could get there.
Again, Dave, the young quarterback not handling pressure well, whereas Theo Dizar, I'm sure the reason why he got pulled like 3 weeks ago was for similar reasons, but in this game has managed and made some better decisions here. Des Catelier, I'm sure he wants to play great at home, but not handling the pressure well, making some bad choices with pressure in his face.
Unless there's an injury we don't know about, I don't understand this move at all by Brian Dobie. Dean Leonard and Esquerdo back to receive this punt. Manitoba with four up backs. Line drive kick by Riley as he makes the most of it. It's going to bounce at the 40, roll to the inside of Esquerdo. He takes it at the 33-yard line, cuts inside to the 40, still on his feet, now taken down. He'll get to about the 43.
Again, solid punt there by Riley. He gets a low trajectory on it. The young returner Esquerdo maybe shouldn't let that hit the ground. It hits the ground, gets behind him, and the Dinos still starting in solid field position. Their own 44-yard line, Dave.
Adam Sinagra got that ball down to the one. Josiah Joseph took it the rest of the way to get the Dinos tied. Nico Defonte right now is the hero with that single point. As the Dinos with a 28-27 lead, as we are just over 7 minutes to go, as we've got an official's timeout on the field.
And again, Dave, let's go back. I mean, I don't know if that's Brian Dobie, the offensive coordinator down there. You see both quarterbacks.
The dynamite hit of the game is on the quarterback, Theo Dizar. Joel Van Pelt. Boom, as Dizar goes airborne, Joel Van Pelt is there to send him to the turf. The dynamite hit of the game.
And the in-house production showing the hit of the game there, Theo Dizar, as he went airborne and got smacked by Joel Van Pelt. As big as it was, that was it that provided a lift to Manitoba as they watched their big quarterback go Sky King. Dino's going to line up in that two tight end set. Jeshua Antwi is the lone setback. Two receivers to the left-hand side. Single man to the right is Michael Klukas. And Klukas over the middle is wide open, but now looking deep with the wind, and that is a pass interference call as the intended receiver.
Again, that is just smart veteran receiver play, Dave.
Justin Dasiak downfield, I do believe.
again, Sinagra, the ball just not coming off his hand well sometimes, even with the win that time. That one hung up there. The defender didn't turn around. The receiver does a great job fighting back for the football. By fighting back for the football, the defender doesn't get his head around. You're going to get that call all the time. So kudos to the Dino receiver. I believe it was Klukas on that play to draw the interference, because that was not a solidly thrown ball by Adam Sinagra.
And R.J. Shelley.
And again, you know what, Dave? If you're beat that clean in college or high school football, you might as well take the interference, because it's only 15 yards, unlike professional football where it's at the spot of the infraction.
I said R.J. Shelley was beat clean on that play. He had his head down and was running. I mean, if that ball doesn't hold up, he doesn't make that contact. Klukas in motion on the right-hand side of the line again, looking left to Sinagra, trying for Antwi out of the backfield, in and out of his hands, incomplete. That'll be second down and 10.
Again, it was, I believe, Dave, that time was Zindani, was in an inside receiver position, just running a quick out. Adam Sinagra throwing that wide side out again. It's a long throw, just a little bit low and a little bit too outside for Zindani's outstretched arms.
6:29 to go. Now 6:25 as the clock is moving. We ought to put some more points on the board here. Klukas on the right-hand side. Sinagra with all kinds of time. Looking for Klukas downfield into double coverage. And Klukas battling with a couple of defenders. Couldn't bring that in. Marcel Arruda-Welch was right on him. It's going to be third down. Great coverage by Manitoba.
Well, there's no question. Double coverage that time. I'm wondering why the impatience right now, Dave? Why not go back to what got you the touchdown in that previous drive? Running the ball, getting into some second and medium situations where you could throw some hooks, you could throw some outs, but I mean, throwing this into double coverage with a one-point lead, I just don't like that decision-making, Dave.
No, I mean, you finally had some success with Robbie Stewart on the ground.
I'm just shocked, one, that they haven't gone back to the running game, and two, you know, some more of this intermediate passing game here. I just don't think you need to go deep. I think you need to chew up the clock and get some more points.
Che Ross and Jaden McCoy back deep this time. Defonte, another bad snap. End over end kick. This one's going to go into the end zone. Che Ross takes it about 5 yards deep. Wants to bring it out and does. Gets to about the 3 yard line before he is taken down. So, well, you don't give up that single point. Doesn't really mean a lot of anything, as a field goal is going to beat the Dinos either way if that stands up.
Again, Dave.
But you get to that 20-yard line by bringing the ball out of the end zone.
Again, you know what? They're dangerous returners, Ross, Walker. And, I mean, they're broken tackle away from taking a big play. If you're Manitoba, what do you got to lose, right, bud?
Yeah.
I mean, I like the idea there. He's an explosive player. You know what? You hit a seam, you're gone. You inject your team here, you know? And, you know.
That's Des Cattelier leading the offense one more time with 5:25 to go. First and 10 from the 20-yard line. Cattelier steps up and skips that ball short. It was intended for Macho Bokru.
Again, thrown into that stiff wind. Basically, that wind took the nose of that football, Dave, and just drove it right into the ground.
Trying to get my head around this quarterback switch and then the switch back.
I'm just wondering, are they developing the young guys? I apologize. I don't know what year Theo Dizar is in. I know he's played for three.
I believe he's at five.
He's at five, so maybe they're trying to develop their young quarterback, Dave.
Yeah, no, you got a chance to win the game. Cattelier rolls right. He's under pressure, and down goes Cattelier. I think that was Micah Tights coming off the edge.
Again, the Dinos overloading the right side of that offensive line of Manitoba. Cattelier, very cerebral quarterback, very accurate quarterback, but not as fast as Dizar, and not as strong as Dizar. Micah Tights was able to get a hand on him and bring him to the ground.
Got a mitt full of jersey. So third and 17.
To me, Dave, really the MVP of this game has been the wind.
Yeah.
I think the wind has made more of an impact than than either team at times, because it just seems whoever has the wind has a total advantage in this football game.
And Matt Riley is a yard inside his end zone waiting for the snap. I wouldn't be overly surprised if he gives up the safety here. This would give the Dinos a 3-point lead. And that is exactly what he is going to do. So here comes the free kick, and then the Dinos, they get the ball back inside 4.5 minutes to go.
And that's really smart, Dave, because he punts it out there. They at least catch it at midfield, maybe better. They score a touchdown, give the safety, as opposed to almost giving up 3 or 7.
Yeah, but hear me out, though. We're kind of splitting hairs on this one. But on that last punt into the end zone, you take a knee, you give up the single, you're down by 2 points, but you take the ball on your 35-yard line. They didn't give up the single, took it on the 20, couldn't move the ball, and now a field goal only gets you a tie instead of getting you the win, best case scenario.
I think that was just Ross, an explosive player, just trying to make a play for his team, Gabe.
Fair enough.
You know what? I think he maybe wanted a spark and hoping that he'd make a big return, you know?
Dinos with the option, take it on their 35, and there is Robbie Stewart, bounce it off, gets out to the 45-yard line. Close to the first down. There's that running game you were talking about.
Well, exactly, right? And I think Coach Sheehan gets that, right? You know, let's go back to the running game. Let's chew up the clock here. You know, we've got a 3-point lead here. Let's chew up the clock. They're not able to move the ball. Nobody's able to move the ball against the wind. And so, you know what? Chew up the clock. Tear up some real estate. If we get three more out of this, great. We can win an ugly one.
Short yardage unit with Josiah Joseph checks in. Last time Joseph touched the ball, he scored. This time he surges ahead, gains 3-4 yards for first down.
And again, Josiah Joseph, similar build to Theo Dizar, 6'4", 220 pounds. That was just incredible push in the middle there by Scirocco, Sevier, and Cron. And Josiah Joseph, for a tall man, gets nice and low, day, and gets like 4 yards.
Game clock starts to move again. Counting down towards 3.5 minutes. Play clock is at 10. Sinagra taking his time as he signals motion on the receivers. And off again to Stewart, and Stewart just surges ahead to midfield for a gain of about 6.
On an ugly, windy day like this, buddy, you get a throwback running back like Robbie Stewart, north, south, no guff type guy. I mean, that time he got so low, he almost tripped over his face mask, you know, but he got 7 yards. I mean, he's hitting those holes hard, giving them second and short. Now you can hit that quick hook, that quick out, or even just run the football again.
And let's see what they do with it. Justin Daziak splitting off wide left. And there is that quick hitter. Hunter Carl fights off a man, 45-40, cuts it back into the 30, and he is down at the 27. First down, Dinos. They are threatening to widen this lead.
Again, Dave, that's smart football, Dave. Smart football, buddy. You're 2nd and 2, 2nd and 3. You hit that quick out. Hunter Carl is one broken arm tackle away from a big play or a touchdown. It's just smart football, right? And that's all set up because of the hard running of Robbie Stewart. You and I talked about it, that the team that would establish a running game was going to take over this game. And the Dinos have established a running game, and it's helping them move the ball down the field.
And you saw the strength of Hunter Carl fighting off that initial tackle, able to gain about another 10 or 15 yards after the catch. 1st and 10 from the 27-yard line. Under pressure, Sinagra. He escapes one tackle. Still under pursuit, trying to signal his players downfield. Now he just throws the ball. That is, Carl says he was inbounds. And they are going to give him the catch.
Looks like they're going to give him the catch, Dave.
No catch. No, the officials talked it over, and they say Carl is out of bounds.
And again, I know Sinagra, Dave, that you don't want him to take a shot. But when you got that much real estate, buddy, even if it's 1 or 2 yards,
yep,
get some positive yards, get out of bounds. He had time. There was no one around him there, right? And, you know, there's opportunities there where you throw a pick after positive momentum. And, you know, you got to at least get a field goal out of this, Dave. You get a field goal out of this, Dave, there's no way, virtually impossible, for Manitoba to drive the length of the field and score a touchdown into this wind.
Play clock is moving. The game clock is not. 2:13. 5 seconds on the play clock. Sinagra takes the snap on 2nd and 10, launches over the middle, complete to Sindani. Sindani down to the 15-yard line, first down, Dinos.
Again, Sindani's a big receiver. He's about 6'2", about 215 pounds. Just runs a nice inside curl route or an in route. He goes down about 10 yards. Smart receiver, gets past the first yard, first down marker, gets good inside positioning, uses that big body to shield the defender away and makes a great catch. Great catch.
There you see Sid Danny making that catch. Houston Rennie on the coverage. Sinagra signals for the motion. Play action, Sinagra rolling right, signaling his receivers downfield into the end zone and out of bounds. No one wide open, so Sinagra really just throwing that one away. Klukas was the receiver in the neighborhood. Richardson Danny made his mark with the Calgary Colts, got drafted by the Calgary Stampeders, had a good camp, was released back to school, had to move from the Colts to the Dino program, which allows the Stampeders to retain his rights for a year under that release to school provision.
I think, Dave, how well he played in the Stampeder camp really, you know, earned the trust of the Dino coaches, but also, you know, forced him to go to school, which is good for him too, you know. And, you know, it keeps him property of the Stampeders. They think he's a great athlete, and I think that kid's got a bright future.
I love that release to school option. I mean, you know, the Stampeders did it with Matt Walter. You see players able to take advantage of it. Adam Lorenz was released to school by the Stampeders. He's now property of the Saskatchewan Roughriders.
But, you know, the good thing about that, Dave, is that, you know, you're one injury away of your career ending. And
yep.
Even when you're negotiating, Dave, and I don't want to, you know, put down CFL general managers in that, but they can really lowball you if you don't have nothing else to fall back to.
Yep.
For example, they know the only thing you're going back to is to look for a job. You know, you don't have as much bargaining power, right? But if you're a top talent and you've got your degree and you can go back and work for a financial company, or
yep,
you can make some good money back home, they're going to offer you some decent money to stick around. So, you know, get your degree. It enables you to have some better bargaining power too.
And it's always the option. You think as a football player, like a Julon Lynch, who was kept by the Calgary Stampeders, they had the opportunity to send him back. You know, are you better off practicing with a pro team or playing with a U Sport team? Second down and 10 for the Dinos from the 15-yard line. Sinagra rolling right again as Manitoba pushing. Sinagra under a lot of pressure at the 30. Throws it. That one is almost intercepted in and out of the hands of Braden Watson. Actually, yep. I think it was Derek Dufault, the defensive end, number 40.
Again, I don't really like this decision making here right now by Adam Sinagra, right? Like, you know, why do you need?
Oh, yeah, no, that was number 90.
I mean, Adamson's already picked you off once, you know, and then by running backwards, Dave, you're taking yourself out of field goal position. Again, that's that read option play. You pull it, nobody's open, run.
Yep.
Run and slide, run and slide. You don't have to take the hit. Don't go backwards when you're in field goal position.
So the Dinos get a little bit lucky on that play as they now have a chance to make it a six-point game. DeFonte from 22 yards. And that one is right through, so it's a six-point game. Manitoba will take over with time on their own 35-yard line. They need a touchdown to win.
And again, Dave, I think the logic here is only you and I can assume is that they want to develop the young quarterback with Theo Dizar being in his fifth year. Want him to perform at home, which is nice, in front of his family and friends, and maybe to give him an opportunity to build his confidence back.
Well, Des Cattelier, you can bet that he's got a contingent of family and friends, former teammates, in the crowd here today. No, they're going to make the Dinos kick this one off after the field.
Well, again,
goal.
You know, again, I don't mind this.
Why not? Drive for the big return.
Well, exactly. You got two explosive returners in Ross and Walker. Those guys could take it to the house. If you're the Dinos, I mean, you got to stay in your lanes. You got to be disciplined, Dave. Now, if you're the Dinos and you can pin them deep, you can almost pretty well put this game away here. But if you give them up a big return, you give the Manitoba Bisons life.
Ross is on the near side. Jesse Walker on the far hash mark. Both waiting for this Nico DeFonte kick down at the goal line. And DeFonte, it looks like that wind is pretty much right behind him as the ball blows off the tee once again.
Bob Strong, yoke, drive. Shot, corner, in. Drive, close,
DeFonte with that cover team bunched up. Now they spread out. Line drive. This one is going to go into the end zone, taken by Jesse Walker, and he fumbles the ball. And let's see where they spot this. It looked like he maybe got it to the goal line. The official is standing in the end zone.
I think they got a single out of it, Dave.
Yep, so that makes it a 7-point lead. Next action for these teams, the Calgary Dinos will hit the road, head off to Regina next week, their first visit to New Mosaic Stadium. Well, Manitoba will be home to UBC on the 21st. Well, and now it's Dizar back behind center. The 35-yard line, kicks the right foot to get the receivers in motion. Dizar over the middle. That one is complete to the 47-yard line.
And you can see the strength of the arm of that veteran, right? He was able to stand in there even with that wind. He's a little taller, a little stronger, was able to get enough force into that hook route to get the first down for the Bisons.
Well, Kyle Patchell had the catch, and we've got a man down. Steven Ugba down at midfield, 1:22 to go. So the Dinos kind of going into that prevent, which neither of us like.
No, definitely not. Especially when you've got Theo Dizar in now, who's had a hot hand today, and he's got a strong arm.
He's got the wind in his face. I say make him go vertical to beat you if you're just going to give him those short passes underneath.
Well, exactly. I mean,
Ugba on his feet, trotting off the field. Dizar getting some instructions.
And again, Dave, this is where the Dinos fell into that same trap too, not capitalizing majors in the red zone. You basically only give Manitoba one major score to tie this game up.
Game clock is moving. Manitoba first and 10 from their 48-yard line. Dizar straight trap under pressure. He's hit. The ball is loose. And I think the Dinos recovered. It looked like maybe Corey Robinson got down on that football.
And again, just a great blitz by Adam Lorenz, timing it perfectly on the short side of the field to the right. Theo Dizar doesn't even see him, and he nails him. And again,
here comes the replay.
Again, you can see that they try and make a short corner for Lorenz. Dizar doesn't even see him. Doesn't even see him. Look, David, they must have been listening to you, Dave, because they went away from prevent, came and pressured, and basically sealed the win there, right? Like that play called.
And Corey Robinson just sort of swam over an ocean of humanity to recover that ball for his first fumble recovery. Dinos had 8 sacks in that last win over Manitoba. That was certainly a big one for them there. With 1:06 to go, handoff to Jeshron Antwi. He cuts back into the line, takes it down to the 32. A late flag comes in. We are inside a minute to go. The Dinos with a 7-point lead and a chance to run this out.
Again, Jeshron Antwi just a little patient running that time, just hiding in behind his O-line, looking for a seam there, and then just putting both hands on the football. You don't want to fumble right now, but it looks like it might be against the Dinos here.
Yeah, hands to the face, I think.
We have a legal block, hands to the face. Number 61, offense, it's 10-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Curtis Cron is gonna have a bad day in the meeting room because that is at least his third penalty on the day.
And I think that's gotta be the Dinos closing in on 20 penalties today, Dave.
Oh, yeah.
And probably close to 200 yards, and that's just totally unacceptable if you're Wayne Harris. I mean, the Dinos have played sloppy. I mean, this is a lot like that football game last night in Hamilton, you know, but good teams seem to find a way to pull these games out, right?
And there's the handoff to Antwi on first down and 20, and Antwi gets it back to about the 40-yard line. And Wayne Harris, I was talking about a bit of a bug going through this team. Flags coming in all over the place late, and Harris has been sick with that bug, and I don't think looking at this game film is going to help him with a speedy recovery.
No,
really.
Definitely not. And again, you know, Manitoba's played a well-played game. They've been very disciplined, and just not a very smart move there that time by Welch. Dave, he goes and nails Jack McDonald in the back like about 5 minutes after the plays ended. And again, you know, I respect Brian Dobie for pulling him off the field. I stand corrected. It is a Rudo Welch there. Just not a very smart play there, Dave.
So we're waiting for the officials to sort out the spot here. 51 seconds to go.
Unnecessary roughness, Calgary number 10. Unnecessary roughness, Manitoba number 8. They offset. Second down.
Well, they called Jesse Walker on that, but seeing as he's an offensive player.
It was Aruda. So obviously Jack McDonald must have done something really bad too and then pretended like he didn't do anything. But had Aruda Welsh controlled himself, they'd have pushed the Dinos back, Dave, another 15 yards. And
wow, what a gunfight between Regina and Alberta. We just got handed the out-of-town score with a minute to go in the game. Regina with a 48-45 lead. Sinagra back to pass, has time, looking for Michael Klukas downfield, incomplete. So the clock stops once again with 46 to go.
Yeah, it looks like Adam Sinagra likes it when Michael Klukas has got one-on-one coverage that time. And I think they went after Aquino Williams because he came in for Welch, right? Might as well pick on the new guy that time, but Williams did a super job staying stride for stride with Klukas, and the Dinos are forced to punt here, Dave.
Hey, kudos to 1-4 Alberta for hanging with 3-2 Regina. If this score holds up, 48-45 Regina into the final minute, Regina would go to 4-2, and the Dinos would not be able to clinch first place even with a win today. So Defonte is going to punt this one away. 46 seconds to go. 7-point lead for the Dinos. It would have been about a 49-yard field goal attempt. You don't want to chance that. Line drive kick. This one is going to go out of bounds.
I think he got it out at the one, Dave.
That is where they are marching over. Let's see how far they go. That is an incredible kick. So Defonte with his second coffin corner kick of the second half down to the one.
I mean, you know what? You don't mind having a 30-yard average when you're putting him out on the... That's twice now, Dave. He's put it out on the 2 and on the 1-yard line. Incredible directional punting by Defonte, Dave.
Theo Dizar, after taking that big, big hit, comes out again. He has a 109-yard field to go and 38 seconds to get it done. Ball blows away. That's how strong this wind is. Even when the ball's sitting on the ground, you can't keep it where you want it.
It's got to be tough to play football out there when the wind makes that much of a difference. But that's the advantage of winning the toss and deferring, Dave.
These are with the drop in the end zone. And that one, you can tell the wind just killed it. Bounced about 5 yards short of Jesse Walker.
And I mean, Theo Dizar can throw that football 70 yards, Dave. You can just see how tough it is.
Yeah, like I say, if you got a guy with a big arm and you got a wind blowing in his face like that, I want to make him throw long passes because it's not going to help him.
No question.
I don't care how strong your arm is.
The only problem with that, Dave, is that you didn't really take that much time off the clock, And mind you, though, I think if the Dinos get it back, they'll probably kneel anyway, right? So
it doesn't really matter, man. Yep. Yeah, 3-down country for Manitoba, even if they turn it over on the one. And Alberta has kicked the field goal to tie this game at 48 with 1 second to go. So they're going to overtime. After the game ends, we are going to send it down to Joe McFarland with Adam Lorenz at field level, get his thoughts on the game.
I mean, this is probably the only time in my life that I'm actually cheering for Alberta, Dave, here, 48-48. I mean, you want to earn your right to clinch.
Wait a minute, the Dino players are signaling safety.
With the ball in the end zone and the foul in the end zone, by rule, we have safety.
Okay, there was a foul in the end zone.
Two more points.
Wow. So what a unique way to get some points here today, Dave. But Dave, I want to get back to that 48-48 score there. I mean, you obviously want to earn your own right to clinch first, but if Alberta wins that game, the Dinos have clinched
first place.
And I mean, you got to give credit to Alberta, Dave. They've been playing some exciting football. They found an offense this year. They've been in a lot of their games. They're putting up a lot of points. They got probably one of the premier running backs in the country. And they've also found some passing games. So, kudos to the boys up north.
That's good. I mean, if they can turn that program around, because that U of A program is a bit of a wasteland for far too long.
And, you know, I want strong programs across Canada West.
We all do, Dave. And when you have two teams in one province, we're the only province in Canada West that has two football teams in a province, it makes it great to have the other team decent, too, for the rivalry games, right, Dave? I mean, lately, it's not much fun when you've got Calgary playing U of A, right? And, again, classy move here, guys. You take three knees, you call it a day, and you move on to fight another day.
And that would be knee number one as Josiah Joseph is in to kill the clock. Took 1 second off there. We'll just wait for this thing to start moving again here. So, again, what a crazy exchange. So, in the second half, Manitoba able to take the lead with the wind, and the Dinos unable to do anything. But Manitoba finished with a couple of field goals instead of touchdowns. That opened the door. Nico DeFonte, after two horrible punts, the third time he had the opportunity to punt, the only series the Dinos moved the ball in the third quarter, he was able to kill that ball down inside the five. So, on to the fourth quarter. The Dinos able to tie it up on the Josiah Joseph touchdown. And then after that, it was Nico DeFonte was the hero on the line drive single point, which right now is your margin of victory.
Well, Davey, my MVP of the game is the coin and the coin toss. I mean, winning the coin toss basically won you the game today, having the wind. But kudos to the Dino defense because they were able to at least hold Manitoba to field goals when they had the wind. And kudos to the Dino offense, which I mean, 455 yards is no slouch, but it wasn't a Dino offense type of game. But you got to give credit to the Bisons. My hat's off to Brian Dobie, getting these kids prepared to come in here, compete, and they did compete, Dave. It was an excellent game, very competitive football game.
I love the energy that Manitoba team showed here today, hanging with the number two team in the country, looking to avenge a 76-17 beating in their own home park. Des Cotelier, the hometown kid, he's got, maybe some better days ahead as he has struggled at times during this game. The Dinos... Yeah, they've got, as we say, some teachable moments coming out of this game. Certainly, they're going to have to cut down on the penalties. Wow. The lack of discipline was a real problem here today. The running game, they need to get that back on track. And Adam Sinagra, again, just needs a little bit of a talking to about some of his decision making.
Well,
I'm
with you, Dave.
Run with the ball.
The one thing that disappoints me, Dave, I think the worst part of his game today was his decision making.
Let's go down to field level where Joe McFarland has Adam Lorenz.
Yo, all right, we are joined by Adam Lorenz here. Adam, a big time play at the end of the game there, but talk about the resilience of your guys' squad today.
Well, we just had to come out, keep playing our football. We knew it was going to be a tight match, but when it comes down to it, we all just balled out in the end. It was good.
Talk a little bit about what you guys have to do to be better for the next few games here heading into playoffs.
We should keep working on our defense, offense, keep getting better, think about ourselves, and just come out, play our football.
Fantastic, man. Congratulations on the win, and good luck next week.
Adam Lorenz from the Dinos. Thank you, Joe McFarland. Dinos hosting University of Alberta Golden Bears in the next game. It's on Saturday, the 28th. 1 o'clock.
Joe McFarland with Adam Lorenz down at field level. Dave Rowe and Tony Spallatini. We've been bringing you all the action from a wild day here at McMahon Stadium. And again, Tony, as you say, the MVP for this game might be the coin as the Dinos won the toss, deferred to the second half, and a Nico DeFonte safety is the margin of victory. So the Dinos stay undefeated pending the outcome of the Regina game. First place is in the balance, but either way, this team with a big statement game coming up next week against Regina, but a lot to clean up.
Well, totally, Dave. I mean, very, very sloppy. One, penalties. I mean, they got into trouble with that last year a couple of times, Dave, where too many penalties, and not so much penalties like holding or procedures in that, like undisciplined penalties. You know, three roughing the kickers, you know, some jockeying here late in the game and stuff. Like, you've got to be disciplined because in some tight games, you're not going to be able to pull it out.
So the Dinos take a 36-27 victory over the Manitoba Bisons. Next game for the Dinos on the road next Saturday at Regina, 2 p.m. Mountain Time for Manitoba. They're home to UBC next Saturday at 2 p.m. Central. For Tony Spallatini, I'm Dave Rowe, bidding you a good afternoon from McMahon Stadium.